session of Science of Self-Realization is, does God exist? Why do we want to know, does God exist? Anybody? Why do we want to know? How does it make a difference? Whether I believe in God or don't believe in God, what difference does it make? Yeah, it improves your faith. And? We need to know who is receiving our prayers. Yes, Prabhuji? Vishal Prabhu? Last session we ended with lot of problems. Isn't it? What are the problems? Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vyadi, Dukkha, Doshanu, Darshanam. Right? And what are other three problems? Adhyatmika, Adi Bhautika, Adi Daivika. So who is responsible for all of this? We have to find out, na? That is the reason we are finding out. Is there anybody responsible or not? That is a continuation, right? So, it's a very important session to go through. Does God exist? Very, very important session. Because without having complete confirmation and faith that God exists, we cannot make progress in spiritual life. Once in a village, you know, one person was called to give a program. One sadhu was called to give a program. Please speak about God. Like that they called him. And how difficult it is to organize a program? Has anybody here organized a program anytime? Anytime. Village, city. So difficult, right? Organizing, then calling people. They don't come. Then following up. Please come. Then they come. They leave in between. Prabhuji, please. You know, so there's so much tension for an organizer. So the whole village was brought together. So much tension was taken to bring everybody together. And the sadhu was brought from some sacred place and said, please speak about God. And the sadhu comes, sits there. And he looks at all the audience and he asks the question, how many here believe in God? He asks. All the villagers look at each other. We all believe in God. Everybody lifts their hand. Immediately sadhu says, oh, so you have called me to talk about God. They already believe in God. So where, what is there to talk? He leaves. Organizer like this too much. You know, with so much difficulty we got everybody. We got you to speak about God and you are leaving. Little notorious sadhu. You know? So next time again, they tell all the villagers, this time when he comes, what is the answer?
No,
don't believe in God. So next time sadhu comes, same again they bring him. Now let us see what he'll do. Now how many here believe in God? We don't believe in God. He says, I have come to speak about God. Nobody here believes in God. What is the point in speaking? He leaves. Then how to make the sadhu speak now? Right? So organize thing, they go for a tactical plan. They say, okay, 50% sit this side, 50% sit this side. So when sadhu speaks, this side should tell, believe in God. This side should tell, you don't believe in God. Now let us see how will this fellow will escape. So the sadhu comes, he looks again. How many here believe in God? He said, we believe in God, we don't believe in God. He said, okay, whoever don't believe in God, listen from the people who believe in God. What is my, why should I speak? He again leaves. So belief in God, right? Does God exist or it doesn't exist? Is a very topic filled with faith, right? Sometimes that faith breaks. For how many people faith has broken? It happens. Very painful it is when the faith breaks, isn't it? We believe in something, somebody, he's there for me, and that person doesn't work out, and doesn't really help me when I'm in need, right? The faith breaks. And then we start questioning, does God exist? There is a there was a bishop from a church. Throughout his life, he worshipped God. He spoke about Jesus in the churches. Everywhere he used to do that. Then after some time, he got married. He had a child, a small child. You know, he took that infant child in a stroller, and he was walking the child. And somebody had a street fight, and somebody shot some bullets. One bullet straight came and killed that infant. Little child died with a bullet on the spot. He lifted the child and said, does Christ exist? Is Jesus the messenger of God? Whom was I preaching all along? If Christ exists, I was serving you. My life I dedicated for you. How did this happen to me? That means you don't exist. Right? You don't exist. Like that. So a lot of people lose their faith. Or rather, their faith is so thin that it can fall flat on the ground. Right? How many here know about redwood trees? Redwood trees. Yeah. Where do you see redwood trees? In California, you see. You know, redwood trees, I'll tell you who don't know about this. You can go to Google and see. Redwood trees are like very tall. Sometimes even taller than, you know, like big buildings. 30, 40 floors tall, the trees. And very thick also. Like, you know, almost like 15 by 15 feet kind of thickness the trees are. And amazing part is, these trees are like thousands of years old. You know, 2,000, 3,000 years old. Some trees are even 5,000 years old. Right? You can see them in, especially in the Bay Area of California. One surprising thing is that the roots of the tree are so small. Barely the root of the tree is from here to maybe till the Prabhuji there. That's it. This imagine the tree's length, sorry, height, and the amount of the length of the roots. So how do you think such big trees are able to stand so many windstorms and so many landslides and so much natural disturbances for thousands of years with such small branches, sorry, roots? How is it possible? The secret is they get interlocked. The way they survive is this tree's roots are interlocked with the neighbor tree's roots. They all interlock. It's like a big network, right? So the foundation is very, very important. How many accept? Foundation is very, very important. It's not about how tall the tree is. How is it holding it? Isn't it? It's not about how tall the building is. A lot of people, you know, they want to buy flat in a big, you know, tall building. Right? What do they go and see? The externals. They see, the Lanco Hills, nice glass they have used. You know, it looks nice. My home guys, you know, it looks nice. Or this another flat, they look nice. Nobody is seeing the foundation. Is that true? Nobody even cares to know the foundation. That is materialistic education. Spiritual education is foundation. Your foundation has to be strong first. Then let us climb anything on top of the foundation. Is that true? This topic is a foundationary topic. I don't know whether you all believe in God or not. But one of my goals today is I want to pull the atheist out of all of you and show him in front of you. Everybody here, there is an atheist sitting inside. We are shy to reveal that atheist. We are okay, let him be inside. Outside, external, I have to look at like a tilak. How much does it cost to look like me? Anybody? I'll tell you, this kurta costs 220 rupees in ISKCON temple. Dhoti costs another, you know, 180 rupees. What is the total? 220, 180. 400. Another 20 rupees, you get Kantimala. Tilak, somebody will give. 420 rupees, it will cost to look like me. And I can make a 420 of anybody. Isn't it? So it's not externals. It's not externals. It's the internals what matters. Foundation is very, very important in spiritual life. Before we go to the topics of does scriptures exist? Why do bad things happen to good people? First of all, does God exist? Right? How firm are we? How clear are we that God exists? See, when we go to a temple, right? We do archana, artai, arti, all that do. Then immediately we come out of that, you know, standing in front of that vigraha, when you just come out a little, then immediately we get onto the phone or we talk some nonsense with somebody. Will we behave like that if we really feel God exists? For example, right now that chair is empty beside Prabhuji. On that chair, Narendra Modi is sitting. Just imagine Narendra Modi is sitting. How will all of us sit? Little. Prime Minister is sitting. Even if you are a Congress person, still, Prime Minister is sitting. Some attention will give or no? Will our behavior be different? It will be different, isn't it? Some important person, designatory sitting there, our behavior will be different. Because we have a faith that Narendra Modi is sitting there. Right? If we have real faith in God, will we behave the way we are behaving right now? If God is everywhere, will we behave the way we are behaving right now? Will not. Problem is actually we don't believe that God is there. Sometimes it's a convenient thing to say, yeah, God is there. Sometimes it is society pressure also. Sometimes parental pressure also. Namura babu, namtanu. God is there, God is there. Better to accept than say no. It's easier to say okay and then move on. Isn't it? So does God exist is a very, very essential topic. Do we have answers for these questions? Why so many rituals? What is the use? Just focus on God. హ్యావ్ అవర్ చిల్డ్రన్ ఆస్ దిస్? ఎందుకు నాన్న ఎన్ని కొబ్బరికాయలు? కొబ్బరికాయలు ఎందుకు కొట్టాలి? గుమ్మడికాయ ఎందుకు వద్దు? రైట్? వెన్ రిచువల్ హ్యాపెన్స్, వెన్ యూ గో డూ గ్రూప్ ప్రొవిజన్, వై డూ ఓన్లీ హ్యావ్ టు బ్రేక్ ఎ కోకోనట్? వై నాట్ యాపిల్? వై నాట్ ఆరెంజ్? టేస్ట్ ఆఫ్ సంథింగ్. వాటర్ ఈస్ ప్యూర్. యువర్ నేమ్ ప్రభుజీ? రాజుగారు. ఎస్. వై కోకోనట్ ఈస్? కోకోనట్ వాటర్ ఈస్ ద ఓన్లీ వాటర్ విచ్ హెస్ నాట్ టచ్ ద యూరిన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ ఫ్రాగ్. ఎవ్రీ అదర్ వాటర్, వెదర్ మంజీరా ఆర్ ఎక్వాఫీనా ఆర్ ఎనీథింగ్, వీఆర్ ఆల్ డ్రింకింగ్ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ యూరిన్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రాగ్. ఎవ్రీ లేక్ హ్యాస్ ఫ్రాగ్స్ అండ్ ద యూరినేట్ ఇన్ దట్, ఇజంట్ ఇట్? కోకోనట్ వాటర్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ వాటర్ విచ్ డజంట్ హ్యావ్ యూరిన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ ఫ్రాగ్. ఇట్ ఈస్ కంప్లీట్లీ ప్యూరిఫైడ్ అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ వీ ఓన్లీ యూస్ కోకోనట్స్ ఫర్ డూయింగ్ అభిషేకం ఆఫ్ ద లాడ్. మేక్ సెన్స్? సైంటిఫిక్, ఇజంట్ ఇట్? యా. సో వై సో మెనీ రిచువల్స్? చిల్డ్రన్ ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్, ఎందుకు నాన్న ఎన్నిసార్లు చంపుతావు పొద్దున్నే? యూనో ఈజీ రిచువల్, హోల్డ్ లైక్ దిస్, డోంట్ యూజ్ లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్, యూజ్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్, యూనో లైక్ దట్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్. Do people who are afraid go to temples? Yeah, sorry. But there is a whole purification plant in between, which is better than our RO system. It's amazing how the first of all the water goes up, right? And then it is stored and slowly it forms and then it is kept. Much pure. Actually rainwater is, they can directly can collect and put it on the lot because there is nothing in between. But as soon as it falls on the ground, the contamination starts. Like that. Do people are afraid to go to temples? Suddenly you are afraid, your child will ask, Nana bayapadutunna kada? That is why you have gone to temple, right? Something happened in your office. Or exams are coming, let's go to temple. Immediately let's go to temple, you know, exams are coming. How many people have taken their children to temple before exams? I take them. You went many times. Balaji, pass karado. Very natural, isn't it? Sometimes I go to the Chilkur Balaji temple. While I go to my farm house, it comes on the way. So there the pujari, I really love that person, the main pujari. He is my wife's relative's relative, kind of. So he sits outside and he shouts at people, Anandra, Govinda, Anandi, Govinda. Okkasarana notlech palkandra, pokkal vetakandi, first Govinda, Govinda, you know. Everybody is busy taking that sheet and putting holes. One by one. Kitne bar guma? 108 bar guma, nahi guma? Kyun? Visa aata, nahi aata? Right? Visa will come or no? Right? But what is the purpose of going to the temple? Chanting the holy names. He says this, Harer Nama Kevalam Kalav Nasteva Gatiranyata. Please chant the names of Hari. Don't come here and rotate for a visa. Aray, you will get a visa that you don't need a visa anymore. Right? You'll go back home, back to Godhead. No need of any visa. But nobody listens to him. Many times when I go, I sit beside him and I chant. He looks at me. Ochindo, iskandi vati. Yena jurandi, chanting chestunadu. Cheyandi andaru. Arvandi. So he preaches. Next time you go to Chilkur Balaji, you see that person. If he's there in the temple, he keeps on telling people, Anandalla, Harinam, Ramudu peru cheppandi, Krishnudu peru cheppandi, Govindudu cheppandi. He keeps telling, yeah. So, one day I went, actually, the procedure of going to Chilkur Balaji temple is first you have to go to Lord Shiva's temple. There is one Shivalingam beside. Yeah, correct. You should go there, you know, pay obeisance to Lord Shiva and then come to Vishnu temple. There is a procedure always. When you go to Tirupati, first you have to go to Kalahasti, then Tirupati, not reverse way around. There is a whole, Lord Shiva is called Kshetrapalaka. He is the one who protects all the dhams. Without his permission, we cannot go to Vishnu. There is a whole procedure. So one day I went to Chilkur Balaji, I went to that, Lord Shiva's temple. And one person came and he paid Shastra Dandavat Pranam in front of Lord Shiva's Lingam, you know. He got up with tears in his eyes, you know. He gave, please, idi devudiki pettandi ani. I was looking at him, wow, you know. I don't even have 5% of devotion that he has. He was crying, literally tears were flowing. I was looking at him, he kept that thing there, you know. And then he brought it back. And then I was wondering what is there inside. Remote, two passports removed. So Lord Shiva stamped Karado. Maybe Balaji did not work out, so he came to Lord Shiva now. know, second attempt of stamping maybe, you know, so whatever. So people go to temples when they are afraid, when they want something. Is that true? Yes. Is it cowardly for anyone to go to temple when they are worried? It's not cowardly. But sometimes we are blamed like that, saying that, you know, you are all cowards, you know, you go to temple only when you want God, something out of God. Are there two gods, one who created us and one whom we created? Maybe. We also created many gods, that is also true. Many fake gods are created now. But did we create God? Or our children can ask this question, right? Is God who made us completely unknowable to us? For example, children might ask, why is it so difficult to see God? Did he make us in such a way that we can't see him? He wants to make sure that he wants to be hidden. Does God want to be hidden? Anybody thinks here God wants to be hidden? Then why are we not able to see him? If God doesn't want to be hidden, then why can't we see him? If your child asks this question. We have so much dust on our eyes, on our consciousness. If we clean that, we can see God. God is right now here. Right now here. He is not only on the altar, he is also with us. But we can't see him because we don't want to see him. Tell me, what if Krishna right now walks out of that room and comes here and sits beside, between both of you, in that chair? What will we do? Sometime we'll immediately we'll put Dandavat Pranam. Then we'll look at him. Then we'll look around, what are others doing? Right? After some time we'll come back and sit, we'll start looking at him. After, why did he come here? Tomorrow morning is Monday morning, I have work. You know, will he allow me to go or what is the plan? After some time, Krishna, what is the plan? Why did you come? That is the reason he's not coming. Understood? God is not coming because we don't know what to do with him. We are not ready for him. God comes, Krishna comes to say, okay, now let us go. Go back to the abode where we actually belong. No, Krishna, 50% pending home loan. I cannot come. You know, or one Audi, Krishna, one time Audi I'll buy. You know, or marriage still not happened. One marriage, then I'll come. So many problems. We are not ready for God. That is the reason he doesn't come. God is not. It's not that he is not there. He's there, but we are not ready for him. That is the problem. When we become ready by chanting the holy names, by understanding Vedic scriptures, when we become ready, when we understand this material world is not a place where I belong, I have to go back to Krishna, then he will appear and we'll actually go with him. Now we are not ready. Right? Okay. Next question. Is religion made by God-man or God himself? Who made religion? There is so much fight over religion, right? Don't follow this religion. My religion is better than your religion. Who made this? God made it or we made it? We made it. Some people might say God made it. No, God only made it. Okay? But do we have confirmed answer for this? We don't have. Right now we don't have. By the end of 12 sessions you'll have. Why are we not born with religion stamped on us? Do you remember this question in some movie? PK. Actually this list is coming from PK only. I used PK in Service of God. I made a whole list of questions from PK. Why do different religions have different rituals? One says like this, one says like this, one says like this. Why? Why so many like this, like this? Why can't everybody be like this? Right? Are different religions like different companies with their gods as their different products? Does a stone smeared with color powder become God? Is every stone God? Once one sannyasi, he was one ISKCON sannyasi. His name is His Holiness. Come on, I forgot. Govind Maharaj. One sannyasi Maharaj. He was traveling in airport and he was traveling through Middle Eastern country. So one person came and sat beside him. And he asked, Maharaj, so sannyasi, you look like a saintly person. He said, yes, I'm a saintly person. Then he asked, so you people worship stone? Like that he asked. So you people worship stone? Like that. So what is the answer he gave? He told very simple answer. If I worship stone, why am I walking on stone right now? Am I not walking on stone? If we all worship stone, have you not come on the stairs? Is that not stone? Is that wood or stone? Stone, right? So how come we are worshipping stone and we are walking on stone? Do you walk on something that you worship? No, right? So we are not fools. We are not idiots to worship stone. We are very intelligent. We don't worship stone. we worship the God in that stone. And every stone we don't identify as God. There is a whole process of calling for God in that stone. It's called Vigraha Pratishtha. There is a whole process. When you have to post your letter, when you post your letter, you have to put it in a red color box. If I paint a red box here, you put it in that, will that go? No, it will not go. When will that go? When that box is approved by Postal Department of India. Is that right? Then only it will go. The same way, when the approval is taken from the right authority, Sampradaya, for a certain Vigraha, that Vigraha will work. We don't worship stone. But all this has to be explained. Right? And there is more answer to it. When God can hear our prayers everywhere, why do we need to go to a temple? Sit here and pray, na? Why you have to go to temple? Can we not ask questions on faith openly? Why do some people become offended asking questions? Biggest problem. Right? The moment I ask, okay, Prabhu, whom do you worship? Prabhuji, I worship this person. Prabhuji is not God. Dekho, Prabhu, see, you started. That is the reason I don't want to discuss. Why? What is the problem in discussing? What is the problem in discussing? Either you don't have faith, or you're not sure whether that person is God or not. Is it not right? So, another, children are going to ask and we'll say, no. No, children will ask, well, Prabhuji told that person is not God. Why are you worshipping him? Atla chappaddu. You know, we are worshipping. Let him say whatever he says. We will do whatever we want. Is that true? Yeah. So, our faith is all futile. Why does God not respond to our prayers sometimes? You know, God is not responding to my prayers. So, there are many questions like this. If we don't have answers to some of these questions, that means actually we are atheists only. Sitting like thieves. How many agree? Don't agree? Jor se laga? I'm sorry. Laga to laga. But such a ye. If we don't have answers to these questions, that means, or some of these questions, we are actually atheists only. But we are just sitting on a very thin line called faith. Very, very thin line, which can break any time. I'm worshipping Ganeshji. If Ganeshji is not working out, then on Tuesday I'll go to some other person. Tuesday not working out, Wednesday God. Wednesday God, then Thursday God. Thursday God, then Friday God. Friday God, Sunday God. Between Saturday God. All these things we are doing. Who wrote that you have to worship somebody on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday? Is it written anywhere? Commercial. Every temple has to run. Right? Some kind of activity has to happen. We are made to believe like that. Ee roju ee gudiki pothe manchi jarugutadi. Ye hafte mein yahan jaane se accha hoga. Hai ki nahi? Ye pura galat hai. Kisi shastra mein nahi hai. Whom to worship, we don't know. How to worship, we don't know. Why to worship also, we don't know. Whether to worship also, sometimes we don't know. Why? Because fundamentally we are not sure whether he exists. Whether he exists or not. If he exists, there is no question. And we don't know who it is. Right? Sometimes, Prabhuji, mere hisab se sabhi log Bhagwan hai. That is that picture also came, na? You see that pictures that they sell, right? Vishnu, Shiva, Sai Baba, Saraswati. All wish list is there in that picture. Who created the design of that picture? Who created? Somebody, some commercial fellow. He thought, if I keep one person, they might buy or not. If it's 10 people, it will sell. Your favorite you choose. Your favorite is there, na? Take this picture. Isn't it? Does it mean all of them are same? Same only, na? Prabhuji, now you are getting into controversies. No, I am asking a fundamental question. Does it mean everybody is same? No. We will discuss about that in 10th session. Who is God? With Shastra, we should learn. Right? With Shastra, we should learn. How to worship God? Whom to worship as what? What is the difference between Devatas and Bhagavan? All these things are big science. If you go to Tirupati Devasthanam, there are certain deities you don't see in Tirupati Devasthanam. Because they follow Sampradaya. Right? But if you create a temple anywhere near your house, you can keep anybody's deity. No problem. At same level you can keep. Nobody is questioning that. But bona fide Sampradayas, they have a bona fide procedure. You cannot go and push your person inside that I believe in this person should be there in the temple. They'll not agree. It's not about we agreeing. Sampradaya Baddha temples will not agree. Right? There is a process. So these all questions are fluid questions which we don't have complete answers to. And science of self-relation actually will make you so strong that you can answer these questions with authority with scriptural reference. Every single question, I can quote a verse from different Puranas and different scriptures and give you authenticity that this is the answer based on this scripture. Don't you think this knowledge is very good? How many want to get this kind of knowledge? Yes, I'm very happy that you all are coming here trying to get that knowledge, because your children will be asking these questions, and we should speak authoritatively with authorized scriptures. What is the situation today? Moment you say religion, read this left side. Everything I like is either illegal, immoral, fattening, expensive, or impossible. I like to do parties, immediately these religious people come. No party, yo, papam, don't go. Everything I like, religion will say no. That is the reason I don't want religion. Is it not right? There is no God. Now stop working and enjoy your life. That is another extreme. Saying that, hey, ne Bhagwan, enjoy. Do whatever you want to do. I am 100% sure on this conclusion. Okay. We are forced to accept God. How many here really accepted God with proper explanation? Like, you see this, forced to pray. This teacher is telling all the children, chalo bachche log sabhi haath jodo bolo, you know, then everybody is saying it. But are those children taught who is God, how to love God? You know, they are not taught. Look at this t-shirt, born to love Jesus. No, forced to love Jesus. You better love, you know, this spiritual personality, otherwise it's a sin. Have you seen how Christians preach outside? Absolutely unbonafide. That is not the way preaching should be done. They absolutely, absurdly, they say, you know, if you don't believe in Jesus, you are going to hell. One day in US, you know, I was there in, what is that, San Jose. So I was taking my cart and going out of the Indian store. One Telugu fellow only, was trying to preach Jesus there. So he was standing outside. So I kept my cart, immediately came behind me. He said, sir, this program is there, this mass, please come, you can learn about God. I told, I already know about God. I don't have any problem, I already know about God. So no, you should learn about Jesus, otherwise it's a problem. He directly told me. He told me, what is the problem? Tell me what is the problem. He didn't know that I preach also. You know, so it was like a unexpected encounter for him. So so I said, okay, beta, chal, bait. Mereko bhi time hai, tereko bhi time hai. Bait. Tell me, who is God? He said, Christ is God. He said, then go to Christ. Why Jesus? No, Jesus is Christ. No, you tell me, who is God first? Jesus or Christ? No, both are same. Both are same. Then you are telling Son of God. Be clear on what you want to say. Then you understand. Yeah. Who are you? He asked. He said, I am a Hindu. I am following. I know who is God. No problem. Then he was like, Christ will take us to heaven. Then what about me? I told, see, I have not done any sin. Will I not go to heaven? So he was hesitant now. I am directly asking a question. Indirectly he has to tell that I will have to go to hell. Is that right? Then I asked him a fundamental question. I asked, see, my grandmother took birth in Nalgonda and she has passed away. She was a very sweet woman, very sweet woman. Anybody used to come home, she used to feed them nicely, like her own children, you know, she used to feed. All her life she never committed any sin. Only problem, she doesn't know who is Jesus. Will she go to hell or heaven? He did not have an answer. Then he understood, oh, this fellow is difficult to convince. Let me go to the next bakra. He went out. This is what is going on. Just threatening people, saying that if you don't follow this, you'll go to hell. You'll go to hell. You'll see so many such mongers outside. You know, those. There was a nice poster somebody kept behind his car. You know, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus, but save me from your followers. Somebody wrote it outside. You know, Srila Prabhupada. You know, our divine grace, Srila Prabhupada, our guru parampara acharya. He told Jesus is our guru. He said he's one of our guru. He told how to be nice with the neighbors. He told the Ten Commandments, thou shall not kill, thou shall not rob. It's a good thing, no problem. But why do you have to conclude that if you're not following Jesus, you'll go to hell? There's no need like that, right? You don't need to threaten people. When you do that is when people become atheists. That is where people don't like religion. Is it not? If you don't, guma agarbatti properly, you've done a papam. You know, then it's a big problem. You use left hand by mistake. My elder son is a left-hander, you know. Sometimes by mistake, he holds that coconut and smashes it with left hand. Immediately, you know, hey, papan jeshnora, papan. Ayyo, he doesn't know what he has done, you know. Now, do you think he'll love God? If God is so mean that with left hand, if he puts it down, it's a problem. Yeah, we can teach him use the right hand. But it doesn't mean that, you know, God will push you to heaven or hell because of that act, right? So do we really believe in existence of God? So where are questions answered? For example, religious child is asking, Mom, why did God let my friend Johnny die? What? I'll just say this one thing. Why did God let my friend Johnny die? What is mother's answer? No one knows but God. It's not for us to understand. Now, if a child hears this answer, what will the child think? Who is this God? God does whatever he wants to do, and we have to accept whatever he does. Does it give a good feeling about God? Definitely not. Yes, we shall prove.
So is the left or the right important, or the intention is more important with which he has broken it?
Definitely.
God likes the intention rather than it is right or the left.
Definitely intention. Definitely intention.
It's the right hand or the left hand.
It matters, but it doesn't matter as much that he has done a sin.
Yeah, it's not a sin.
It's not a sin.
Until the intention is good, the God has never bothered this.
Shastra says, Bhavagrahi Janardana. Bhavagrahi. Bhav dekhte hain Bhagwan. Intention is what matters, definitely. But there is also ordainment that we should use right hand for pure activities, left hand for impure activities, right? Like when you go to nature's call, you use left hand. So naturally you don't want to use that hand to, you know, put flowers on the god or put water on the god with that intention. Just your purity, you yourself will not use it. That's the whole intent. But intention is what matters, definitely, at the end of the day. Yes, absolutely. Bhavagrahi Janardana, as I told. Bhavan Jushavad Bhavantudu. So, this is the answer. So, look at this book. This book is a bestseller in Western countries. Growing up Godless. A Parent's Guide to Raising Kids Without Religion. And it's a bestseller. Right? And teachers, you know, this modern teaching system opinion. They are saying basically, we should not allow God to enter into school. Children should not be taught that God exists. It has gone to that level. It's already gone to that level. Right? When I tell, sometimes in schools, you know, I tell people, you know, we'll do a Bhagavad Gita session for children. No. Religion. Should not allow. What is wrong in Bhagavad Gita? No, it's secular. I said, okay, do Quran session also. Go Bible session also. No religion. No religion. What does it mean? Already it has come to a point. If we don't teach our children who is God and what is the importance of God in our life, then they'll become godless. Just a matter of time.
Atheistic society.
Yes. Does God exist? Maybe science is more powerful than God. This is another big bombardment of science. Science can do what God cannot do. Actually, I'll tell you, one of the biggest instrument that makes all of us atheists is this mobile phone. It makes us feel that we are king of the world. You can Google anywhere, see anything, whatever you want. It gives a false sense of pride. I'm in control of the world. I'm in control of my life. Just because I have that mobile phone. I'm in access to everything. Your email ID gets blocked, you cannot sleep that night. Is that true? Your Facebook ID is, you know, what is that, barred or blocked, you lose all your friendship. There is no one to call as friend, isn't it? That's horrible. Your other day, you know, one person is in anxiety. He doesn't have enough followers on Instagram. Hey, I'm famous. I have to become famous. Hey, Baba, you are famous. No, I'm not famous. There are only 20 people following me. Right? So that is how people have become. So insecure, godless civilization. So does God exist? Is science? Look at this poster. I got this in internet. Science and religion. What do you see in the first picture? Both the cases, there are children without legs, you know, or injured legs. What is science doing? Fixing it. After that, what are they doing? Running. What is religion doing? Praying. After that, what are they doing? Limping. Can you imagine the way they are spreading atheism? If this is what religion is? Is religion against science? No. Religion is not against science. Is Ayurveda science? Is it part of Vedas? Is Dhanurveda science? Is it part of Vedas? We are not against science. Science takes birth from religion. To understand religion, you can use science. But what is science doing on the other side? It is spreading atheism. I believe in higher powers but not God. Have you heard this? Go and ask some people. Do you believe in God? Yes. Who is God? Some higher power is there. I don't want to know if he has a name. Naam mat do Bhagwan ko. Naam dete hi problem aayega. Don't give name. Why to give name to God? Let him remain God. Let him remain God. That is the biggest problem. Atheist only. Basically, he is atheist. He doesn't want to be touched. He doesn't want a name. I'll talk about the name later. We're all born atheists until someone starts telling us lies. What is the source of wisdom in our society today? Where do you learn about God? Most of us, where did you learn about God from? Storybooks. Or Swati magazine. Or one article in Inadu. Amar Chitrakata. Who are the heroes who showed about God to us? Some of them. N.T. Ramarao. Right? Or this person who played Krishna's role in B.R. Chopra. Or Nagarjuna. Annamaya. Ramdas. All this, right? You know what these people do? They don't actually give us faith. When you see the true side, it breaks our faith. Same people. Look at that N.T. Ramarao. What is he doing with Sridevi? After that, Krishna's movie and all that. What is that Nagarjuna doing? What is that Arjun doing? And what are these PK and Oh My God movies doing? How do you think faith will be remaining in people if these are the people who are representing? Will it remain? It's so horrible, isn't it? As a child, I had so much respect for this person. This person, I forgot his name. Anyone remembers? Ritesh Bharatwaj. Nitesh Bharatwaj. So much respect I had for him. Then I saw this movie. I said, what nonsense is this fellow? After explaining Mahabharat, Bhagavad Gita, for 4 episodes in B.R. Chopra Mahabharat, you are behaving like a rogue. You are behaving like an ordinary, person. What transformation it has brought in you? Nothing. Right? This girl who played Draupadi's role. I had to choose a decent photograph to keep here. Don't search with her name in internet. Horrible things you will see. And she was playing Draupadi's role. You know how pure is Draupadi? Lot of people, they think Draupadi so less. So many people like Devadat Patnaik and all, they comment on Draupadi like anything. Krishna's wives, in Srimad Bhagavatam it is there, Supreme Lord Krishna, his wives, Rukmini, Satyabhama, all of them, when they were leaving, they came for a visit to Hastinapur. And they were leaving Hastinapur and going back to Dwarka. At that time, all of them together came to Draupadi and they asked Draupadi, can you please teach us how to nicely take care of husband? Can you teach us how to be a chaste wife? Whom are they asking? Draupadi. Who is Rukmini? Whose expansion is Rukmini? Lakshmi Devi. She is Swayam Lakshmi Devi. Lakshmi Devi is asking Draupadi how to worship Narayan. And a fool like Devadatta Patnaik is commenting on Draupadi. And thousands of idiots are sitting in that hall and saying, what a interpretation, Devdutt. What a great interpretation, you are writing about Draupadi. This is going on. Nobody reads Shastra. Nobody understands the greatness of these people. Draupadi did tapasya in her previous life that she wanted to get a husband who was the most beautiful, most chivalrous, most powerful, most dharmic, and the most, relationship building person. Very, very loving person. When she did the tapasya to Lord Shiva. Mahadev appeared. Immediately Mahadev appeared. Ashutosh. Immediately he'll become very happy. Bholenath. He asked, okay, what do you want? I want this kind of husband. Immediately Mahadev told, Amma, what you're asking cannot be in any human being. Only Lord Narayan has all these qualities. Only Lord Narayan. It cannot be in one person. But she became stubborn. No, I have to get. You came, you have to give me. He told Tadastu. And what is the reason? What is the result? 5 husbands she got. Because not one person will have that quality. When Draupadi complained, why did she get 5 husbands? Krishna came and reminded about her previous life. This is the reason you got. Right? The whole episode and how they maintained the chastity between a wife and a husband cannot be understood by ordinary people. People who watch today's television cannot understand Mahabharat. You need a different level of maturity to read Bhagavatam, to read Mahabharat, to read Bhagavatam. You need lot of correction in our consciousness. But unfortunately, people like this are today are representing and showing us what is religion. And who are our role models today? Film actors, right? Virat Kohli, other day Dhoni. When Tendulkar used to play, I still remember in Abbott's center, one big board, God of Cricket, you know, and below Tendulkar, like that. Just making anybody as God, isn't it? There are role models. And look at this, some of the role models. I have not chosen many Telugu role models, but look at what this great Shah Rukh Khan is telling. I feel very strongly about souls who are misguided people in the name of religion. Who the hell is he to speak about it? Look at his photo beside. What good habits does he have? What good culture he maintains? And he is talking about religion. Look at Kamal Haasan. What is he saying? People ask me, is yours an atheistic principle? Boldly I replied, no, atheism is my tool. Humanitarianism is my principle. What humanitarianism you can do without accepting God? What humanitarianism you can do? Okay, I am giving food danam to 10,000 people. Where did you get that food from? You created that food? Who created that food? From where did that grains come from? Did you create that? It's like somebody comes to your house, opens your door, gets into your fridge, removes everything, gives it to beggars and says, I am Mahan. What will you tell that fellow? He got into your house, came into your refrigerator, removed all the things from the refrigerator, gave it to beggars and said, I am Mahan. Will you call him Mahan or robber? Robber. That's all it is. Humanitarianism is a subset of bhakti, of religion. Today it is shown as something great. What is that? One institution started propagating this. What is that? Manava Seva, Madhava Seva. Absolute nonsense. Madhava Seva, Manava Seva is right. Madhava Seva automatically results in Manava Seva. Why do you have to say Manava Seva is Madhava Seva? You are reducing Madhava? You are reducing God? You worship God. Automatically you will become a right person to serve the society. Can you tell me how much did Azim Premji donate recently? Some crores of rupees. How many papers it came? Every paper it came. Whenever some celebrity donates something, it comes in all the papers. How many plates of prasadam does one Tirumala Devasthanam give in a day? More than a lakh. More than 1 lakh plates of... And let me tell you, with no doubt, the quality of rice and dal and all the ingredients is better than our houses. High class. No compromise. And how is it served? Does anybody come and say, Inte, tinte din ladavo. You want more? How many have gone to Udupi? Have you had the Dharma Bhojanam in Udupi? How they give? The sannyasi of Udupi comes and reviews. When I went, it was Vishveshwar Tirtha Maharaj. He was coming and reviewing, you know, whether this person is served or not. And how much do they charge? Zero. How much do Tirupati charges? Zero. ISKCON temples all over the world supply more than 20 lakhs of full prayed prasadam every single day. Do we put it in newspapers? 20 lakh plates. Do we show it in papers? Do we need to show? People who are following religion don't show off. Philanthropy is natural for somebody who is religious. People who want to do business in the name of humanitarianism do all kinds of publicity. And they say that Manava Seva, Madhava Seva. Serving hands are better than praying hands. All idiotic talks. Why praying hands? What is the problem? What is the problem praying hands? Do praying hands don't serve? They don't serve. Ente se pooja chestunnaru. Why don't you go and help others? Huh? Sometimes, you know, one person came, Prabhuji, we do Abhishekam in our house. We have Nithai Gaur deities and Jagannath deities. We are doing Abhishekam. Oh, you put so much honey, you put so much curd, you put so much ghee. Why can't you go and feed the poor people? What do you get by putting all that on God? Have you heard this question? What is the answer for that? What brand shoes are you wearing? Nike. Why, you can wear Bata, na? What is the difference between Nike and Bata? 4,000 rupees. Go feed the poor people. Ah, Prabhuji, adi vere. You know, my shoes are my shoes. My car is Audi. Why you have to go in Audi? Why can't you go in public transport? Metro is good only, right? Go in metro, take your auto. What is the difference between auto and metro? 50 lakh rupees. Go give that to poor people. Prabhuji, this is not right. Why it is not right? The amount of money women spend on makeups can feed the whole world. Prabhuji, now you are directly attacking women. Why? The amount of money men spend on useless electronic gadgets can feed all planets. No reason. For that you will not... Don't bring God in there. Don't bring poor people. But somebody becomes a little, you know, gratitude towards God. Krishna, you are doing so much for me. I want to offer something back to you. And immediately question comes. Why are you doing this to God? Huh? Why don't you do it to poor people? Who are you to first of all question me? Just imagine all of you fathers sitting here. You all have come back from office. And your child, now he might be grown up, but just imagine when he was 3 years old. And while coming back, your child likes dairy milk chocolate. You brought a dairy milk chocolate to your house. And your son, you know how excited he'll be. Is that true? He'll be very excited. My father got dairy milk. So he comes open, Nana, you have come, yes. And you remove the dairy milk from your laptop bag. And you give it to him. And the son takes the dairy milk. Hooray! He jumps. And he runs into the hall. Amma, Amma, I got dairy milk. The wife is shouting, why are you spoiling his teeth? And the child takes the dairy milk and stops. Just for a minute he stops. He opens. He comes back to you. Breaks a little. Gives it to you. Nana, eat. Tell me how sweet is that little piece of dairy milk. You only bought it. But your son is giving a little piece of it back to you. That little piece of dairy milk is much sweeter and much precious than any increment or promotion or any growth in our career. That little piece of dairy milk. That is called love, showing love towards God. Krishna is giving me milk. I want to give little milk back onto him. Pure milk. He's giving me ghee. I want to give little ghee back to him. He's giving me honey. I want to give some honey back to him. Right? Is there a problem? And what happens after that whole honey goes down? What happens after that whole thing falls? Are we throwing it in drainage? What do we call that? Teertham. Panchamrutam. Right? Or Murti ka alag name hai na? What do you call that? Charanamrut. Charanamrut. We say Charanamrut. In our society, it is Charanamrut. It comes back, we give it to the whole world. Take it. Actually, the temples... I don't like when temples just break the coconut and give the coconut piece. No, it is not supposed to be like that. It all has to go to the Lord, touch the Lord's feet. It should be given back. Nothing should go waste in a temple. Nothing. In fact, in our temples, even the flowers that are offered are after the day, those flowers are brought and put in a garden. In our house, we put so many flowers every day, at least this much. Right? And all those flowers after the deities, we put them in a cover, put them in our farmhouse. So the manure goes, you know, the blessing goes back into the earth. Right? That is how we treat, that is how devotion is. Everything is utilized. Right? And we tell me how much prashadam would have been distributed during the 11 days of Ganesh Utsav? Can even one beggar die of hunger during Ganesh Chaturthi? Now Navaratri is starting. Can even one beggar die of hunger? I can tell you, nobody on the planet can die of hunger. God provides for everybody. Everybody God provides. Problem is, our desires are not right. Can you tell me how far an ant goes to find its food? Ant. How far does it go? It comes out of the hole, like this it goes. Within 10 meters, 10 also is very high actually. Within 4 or 5 meters, it will find its food. Ant will go by. How far does a dog go to find its food? Half kilometer? Somewhere it will find. How much does the elephant eat? 50 kgs a day, minimum. Minimal diet. How far does the elephant go to find its food? 2 kilometers maximum. Maximum 2 kilometers. Human is the only guy who has to go countries and countries to find his food. Because he doesn't have any faith on God. Don't you think God has created food for us? Have you seen any elephant dying of hunger and without food? But a human being will die. Because his desires are like that. Right? Our faith on God is zero. Bhagavantudu istadu anna namakam ledu. Bhagavantudu potta kavalsina istadu, bojjakiyadu. In Telugu you say, I don't know how to put in English. How to put in English? Right? God can give for your stomach, not for your belly. There is everything God can give for everyone's need. But even God cannot give for one person's greed. Greed is so horrible. Even God cannot give. Because a greedy person, nobody can satisfy. And such greedy people declare that God doesn't exist. And some of these greedy people are all these celebrities that you see. Our role models are these people today. And God's knowledge is called brainwashing. Somebody was telling me, Prabhuji, in your sessions, you really do brainwashing. Once somebody told Prabhupada, you do brainwashing. Prabhupada told, yes, we wash all the dirt out of your brains. It's brainwashing only. What to do? Huh? The moment you talk about religion, there is a problem. Religion is the only subject where anyone can arrive at any conclusion without any guidance or knowledge. Is that true? In all other subjects, there is no argument raised when need for training is asked. After all, God is the safest thing to comment, as God never corrects you immediately. You can say anything about God. Five drunkards can sit. After five pegs, they can talk about Krishna, Rama, everything they can talk. And they can arrive at conclusions also. One person came to me and told, you know, Prabhuji, you know why fully drunk? You know why Krishna wears Namalika, that peacock feather? I was expecting some great answer only, obviously. That fellow is drunk. What is it? He eats peacock every day. What nonsense. He eats peacock every day. Right? You can come to any conclusion. Why Krishna will not come and slap him, na? Krishna is sitting there. He'll say, Janma Mrutyu Jara Vyadhi Savu. That is the biggest punishment. Take birth again. But this fellow doesn't know that that is a problem. Isn't it? Humanitarian without God. Isn't that atheism? Look at this. Humanitarianism is the real, is a better label. We can all be good without God. These many people. There is a whole society, foundation, rolling forward in Western society. And now it is also coming to India. Today it's a big thing to say that, you know, we are godless. Today, if in office I go and tell somebody, if I tell my teammate, may God bless you, he'll look at me. What did you tell? May God bless you. Entra mata. Let's not get into that kind of. You are less intelligent people if you are talking about God. Is it not right? It has become like that. Telling God bless you is a big problem in India. So many Gitas. Every Tom, Dick and Harry is writing his own Gita. I've just got few collection. Don't look for your favorite there. There are many others. Everybody is writing his own Gita. Even this fellow. What is it? Look at this fellow. Down. And what is the Gita name? Bhagavad Gita by Nityananda. No questions, only doubts. I do not understand what it means. Right? Everybody. Gita cannot be written by anybody. Prabhuji and Mataji's Gita is only written by one person, Ganeshji. It was recorded by one person, Vedavyas. It was told by one person, Krishna. It was heard by one person, Arjuna. And it is translated and presented as it is in Sampradaya. That's all. Don't need to interpret anything. If you read all these Gitas, you are gone for sure. You know, there is no point in discussing. When we ask general people about God, what are the responses? When we ask, Prabhuji, what is God? What do you hear? God is love. God is light. God is nature. Isn't it? God is power, God is everywhere, everything, omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient. God is you, God is me, that version is also there. God is infinite. Well, are these answers wrong? No. They're not wrong. But are they complete answer? No. If you go in your apartment, knock every door and ask, is God great? What is the answer you'll get? Yes. Yes, God is great. How great is God? I don't know. How great is God? I don't know. That is where all these fake gods are coming. For example, I do like this and this chair goes up. Am I God? I am God. In today's society, I am God. Just because I lifted this chair. Just imagine Ravana taking birth now. Ravana could get 10 heads on a click of a hand. 10 heads. 10 heads like this. You cut those 10 heads, again another 10 heads. Will he be declared as God? In Kali Yuga, yes. Anything you cannot do, somebody does, he's a God. Understanding? I opened a rice bag, somebody's name came out. He's God! His name came out from rice bag. I was thinking about him, I saw his name. He's God! I was just thinking about him, his name came. One person became a Christian because he met with an accident, and when he raised his eyes at that accident spot, it was written, Jesus saves you. He became Christian. Because the name board is there. What is the basis of declaring who is God? What is the basis? Is there any logic? You are thinking about somebody appeared. Prabhuji, the same person can appear in three places. Then he should be God only, na? So many people can do that. So many mystics can do that. Right? What is that? Surpanaka. She could change herself in any way she wants. If Surpanaka takes birth in India now, she'll be Surpanaka Amma. Amma. Amma Bhagwan. Surpanaka. She'll become that also. Because fools are there. You can make fool of anybody. Just take like this. Throw ash on the face. Bhagavan! You are the Bhagavan. Why? Why is Bhagavan? He throwed what? Ash. What will he get by getting ash? Take 20 kgs ash. Go to Nike shop. Will he give a shoe? What will he do with that? Nothing. By doing what, you are declaring whom as what? Where is the sense? Where is the sense? Why are we... This is what is spreading atheism. When you don't know how great is God, then you start making everybody as God. That is the problem. You following me? It's very important to know how great is God. Is there a definition of God? Parasaramuni gave the definition of God. Who is Parasaramuni? Father of Vyasa. He gave a definition of God, which I'll discuss in 10th session. Detailed discussion I'll give. But we should understand. God is great. How great is God? We don't know. No answer. Let me just finish the ritual. Let's not get into the trouble of who is God, what is God, whatever it is. Let me just finish it. Fear of God. Most people believe in the conception of two reasons. One is fear of unknown and fear of society. One of my friends, actually me and my friend, we both are strong atheists in our college time. Strong atheists. Even I was an atheist. I never used to believe, you know, people when they come. Because nobody gave me proper answers. Let me put, why I was an atheist? Because nobody gave me answers. Then, this friend of mine, then I, somehow Krishna saved me. I came into the right path. I started reading scriptures. I could understand something. But this friend of mine never went to any such path. And some years back, he told me, I am doing Groh Pravesham, please come. I was shocked. Hare, you are such a big atheist. Why to do Groh Pravesham? Right? Groh Pravesham means only God conscious people do, na? Then I went just to know why is he doing. I went there. So I sat through the whole Groh Pravesham. How much is the flat for? He told 1 crore. Sorry, 75 lakh, something like that. He told. After the whole Vratam, I called him, Edara, what are you doing? You don't believe in God, right? Why are you doing all this? You know what he told? He told, hey, 75 lakhs pettanu. 3000 pedithe bhagavanthudu unte santoshapadtadu. Kadam. I put 75 lakhs. 3000 rupees if I put. If there is God, he'll be happy. Why to unnecessarily take risk? If he's there, he'll be happy. Whole relatives, swaha, 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 everything he did. This is called atheist sitting like a theist. This is what is going on. These days I see people sitting in track suits in Satyanarayana Vratam. Right? Neckar, Bermudas in Satyanarayana Vratam. T-shirts. Some people are like, no, I don't want to remove my shirt. As if he look like Arnold. So much shy to sit in front of God. See? There is no God consciousness there. It's all a ritual. It's all a ritual. That's all it is. Introspect. Why are we hesitant to ask questions about God openly? Do we fear declaring the existence of God will remove our independence? If I prove that God exists, suddenly I'll be scared now to live. Isn't it? Better to keep him in that cat on the wall situation. Whether his God exists or doesn't exist, let him be on the wall. Then, till then, I can do whatever nonsense I want to do. Do we feel that we will be asked to follow new boss with new rules? Now Prabhuji will prove that he is God. Now I have to learn what all he likes, what all he dislikes, what all he dislikes I should not follow now. I have to follow. Right? Do we feel God is actually not part of my daily life? So why ask questions anyways? Anyway, I don't feel him part of my daily life. Right? Most of our situation today, parents never told answers. You can read this. We are working 24/7/365 for survival. We don't have time to know about God. Reading scriptures by own self is difficult, many times boring. Many reasons why our situation today is basically, for example, I sent an invite to so many people. Right? Some of you came because you are interested. Why so many others did not come? The invite might have gone to at least 10,000 people. In that 10,000, 200 people registered, 50 people disappeared. Some people are appearing here. Why? I'll tell you why. Simple. Krishna only told in Bhagavad Gita, Bahunam janmanamante jnanavan mam prapadyate vasudeva sarvaiti samahatma su durlabha. Durlabham. Krishna is telling. Among, after taking thousands and millions of births, Bahunam janmanamante, one person aspires to go for knowledge, self-realization knowledge. You following me? Not Aragara knowledge. Yeah. What is everybody busy with? Job, wife, family, relatives, properties, wealth, beauty, body, all that. But among thousands, after thousands of births, one person comes forward and says, I want to know what is going on. First, let me understand why did I take birth. Jnanavan mam prapadyate. He inquires about God. And among such rare people, when you combine such rare people into millions, one person comes for truth, absolute truth. He says, okay, I want to know the truth, only truth. I don't want to know something that I like or dislike. I want to know only the truth. Krishna is telling, not my verse. Vasudeva saham sarvaiti. That is even difficult. Meaning, see, among billions, after millions of births, some people ask the question, what is going on? Among such millions, one person comes for hearing the truth. And among such zillions and millions, one person, Vasudeva Sarvaiti, one who understands that the cause of all causes is Krishna, Vasudeva Samahatma Su Durlabha. Now you tell me, if I am seeing 150 people in this hall, should I be enthusiastic, optimistic or pessimistic? Optimistic. This is a miracle. I told my Shiksha Guru, I told Prabhuji, this year also I need your blessings. I'm conducting this session. He said, how many people are coming? I said, Prabhuji, around 120. He fell down, What? 120 people are, what did you tell them? Are you cheating them? No, I didn't tell anything, Prabhuji, they are coming. So rare. So rare, Prabhus. You are not ordinary. Don't think you're ordinary. You are one among the rarest who are actually coming to get this knowledge. Invest your time. One among the rarest. And whatever you are learning here today is not going to go waste. You are not going to leave this knowledge. Arjuna asks Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna, what happens to that yogi who cannot finish his entire process in this lifetime? Krishna answers, Neha Bikramanashostri Pratyavayano Vidyate Swalpam Apyasya Dharmasya Trayate Mahato Bhayat. Little he learns, little he understands me. Swalpam apyasya dharmasya. Little dharma he follows. Swalpam. Swalpam is an easy word. Koncham. Apyasya dharmasya. Trayate mahato bhayat. I will deliver him for the greatest fear. What is the greatest fear? Death. I will come with my hands. I'll hold this person on 15th September in Kondapur. You attended. Come with me. I'll take you. That is called mercy. You don't have faith, right? प्रभु जी ऐसे बोलता है, वन डे आई अटेंडेड कृष्णा विल कम, कृष्णा विल कम फॉर इवन वन सेकेंड. हैव यू सीन जगन्नाथ एनी टाइम? जगन्नाथ, जगन्नाथ डिटेल्स हैव यू सीन? हु इज जगन्नाथ? कृष्णा. देर इज द होल स्टोरी ऑफ जगन्नाथ. हाउ मेनी आर हैव गॉन टू पुरी? यस, दैट प्रभु जी इज फ्रॉम पुरी, बॉर्न इन पुरी. यस. सो यू नो वाई जगन्नाथ आईज आर सो बिग लाइक दिस? इन द पिक्चर्स ऑल्सो वन आई विल सी ह्यूज आईज लाइक दिस. We have Jagannath's eyes, you know, we have Jagannath deities in our house. Why we kept instead of Krishna Jagannath? Krishna sometimes sees faults also. But Jagannath never sees faults. Jagannath's eyes are so big because he is eager to see even one small thing that you do right. God is so great. You know, as soon as you do some nonsense, he closes his eyes. I don't want to see what wrong my devotee is doing. I only want to see what right is. That is how mercy of God is. That is why he is so great. Right? But our situation today is so bad. When that Jagannath comes out of the temple to see us, because we are not going to the temple, we don't have time to go and see him. We don't have time to go and see him. Do you know that Jagannath Rath Yatra happens in Hyderabad also? How many places it happens? Abbots. Secunderabad, different dates. Panjara Hills, Kukatpalli, Balnagar, Uppal, Alwal. So many places it happened. Even in our apartments, recently when Mataji got ecstatic, she brought her Jagannath outside, showing everybody, you know, Jagannath, look at these people. Do you know the meaning of darshan? Nak manchi darshanam ayindi, darshanam ayindi, vittil, right? Hendra, Tirupati poyinava, poyina, darshanam ayinda, super. Is bar achcha darshan huwa. What is the meaning of darshan? You seeing God, I have seen him top to bottom. Is that darshan? No. Prabhupada explained darshan from a shastric angle. He said, darshan means not you seeing God, God seeing you. That should be the consciousness when you are in front of God. Krishna, see me. I am such a fallen fellow, useless. I am struggling between birth and death. Give one glimpse on me. One glimpse on me. That's enough. That is called darshan. One glimpse. Because just understand, God is the most beautiful. God is the most beautiful entity in the universe. And if you see God, if you see God, can you see anything more beautiful after that? Is it possible? You've seen God. Venkateshwar Swami Balaji. Chusavu Bhagavantunni. Dan tarvata edaina nachutada? Will you like anything? But what happens? వెంకట స్వామి వెంకటరావుడా వెంకటరా గోవిందా గోవిందా తిరిగాను ఎక్కడ పోదాం భీమాసా లేకపోతే వుడ్లాండ్సా వేర్ ఇస్ ద దర్శన్ దట్ మీన్స్ డిడ్ యూ యాక్చువల్లీ హ్యావ్ దర్శన్ ప్రభుపాద్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ వెన్ యూ యాక్చువల్లీ సీ బాలాజీ వెన్ యూ యాక్చువల్లీ సీ ఉడుపి కృష్ణ వెన్ యూ యాక్చువల్లీ సీ రాధా మదన్ మోహన్ వెన్ యూ టర్న్ బ్యాక్ యూ షుడ్ సీ ఓన్లీ డార్క్నెస్ దెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ హ్యాడ్ దర్శన్ వెన్ యూ టర్న్ బ్యాక్ చీకటి కనబడాలంతే అప్పుడు నీకు దర్శనం అనేట్ లెక్క అది దర్శనం వెన్ యూర్ టర్నింగ్ బ్యాక్ యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ అండ్ యూఆర్ సీయింగ్ ఆపర్చునిటీ న్యూ డిజైర్స్ మనీ వైఫ్ బ్యూటీ వాట్ డస్ ఇట్ మీన్ యూర్ నాట్ సీన్ గాడ్ దట్స్ వై యునో డివోటీస్ ఆర్ వెరీ డిఫరెంట్ వెన్ దే టేక్ దర్శన్ దే గో అండ్ బెగ్ ఇన్ ఫ్రంట్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ దే డోంట్ గో విత్ రికమెండేషన్స్ దే గో అండ్ ఫాల్ కృష్ణ ఇఫ్ యూ డిజర్వ్ ఇఫ్ ఐ డిజర్వ్ ప్లీజ్ అలౌ మీ టు కమ్ ఇన్ ఫ్రంట్ ఆఫ్ యూ దట్స్ ఆల్ No MLA, no MP, nothing needed. Whatever is your wish. If I don't get accommodation, I'll sleep on the floor in Tirupati, no problem. I don't want to any recommendation room. If you want me to sleep in a room, you will provide me. If you want me to come to you will allow me to come. Ramanujacharya, when he climbed Tirupati, he climbed on his knees. On his knees. Because he said, this is Seshachalam. I cannot keep my feet on Vaikuntha. He came on his knees and there was no road. He climbed on his knees. And after having darshan, he took the prasadam and they all left. And they left again on the knees, came till down and then started walking. Far away, they crossed many, many villages. Then when they opened the prasadam box, there were ants in that. Ramanujacharya shouted at his servants, do you know what you have done? They packed that box, again went back to Tirumala, climbed the hill, left the ants there. They are Vaikuntha Vasis. After how many births they have taken birth on this Seshachalam? What right did we have to remove them from that place? This is called heart of a devotee. The one who actually takes darshan. Right? Next time when we say darshanam ayinda, think whether darshanama ain't mayana. Right? That is our situation today. Does God exist? Nobody knows. Now, one scientific way of telling it. Yes, Prabhu. Yes, done. Desire. First, you should have a desire for that. Do you have a desire for that? Yes, done. It will be fulfilled. We should have desire for that. Lot of people don't desire that. They are scared. అంటే తిరిగా తిరిగా ఏం కనబడదా? నా ఇల్లు, నా వ్యాపారం, నా భార్య, నా పిల్లలు, వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపెన్ మై ఫ్యామిలీ? వీఆర్ నాట్ యాక్చువల్లీ డిజైరింగ్ గాడ్, వీఆర్ స్కేర్డ్ టు ఆస్ గాడ్. రైట్? సో వన్ ఆఫ్ ద వేస్ ఆఫ్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్, డస్ గాడ్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్? నౌ లిటిల్ సైంటిఫిక్ థాట్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద టైమ్? టైమ్ 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 7:30. ఓకే, వీఆర్ ఆన్ టైమ్. నౌ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద వేస్ ఈజ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ అర్జ్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఆన్ దిస్ ప్లానెట్. If you have to explain your children, does God exist? I'm going to give you some answers now. Whatever urge is there a fulfillment? For example, we have a thirst. I'm also feeling thirsty. What is the urge is thirst? What is the fulfillment? Water, isn't it? Urge is thirst. Fulfillment is water. What is perverted? Liquor, artificial drinks. That is not needed, but they are extras, isn't it? Next, hunger. What is the fulfillment? Food, vegetables, opening slaughterhouses. That are not needed. Food is there, isn't it? Sex. What is the fulfillment? Marriage. A male marries a female. Done. Perverted, I don't want to discuss. Name one urge you have which doesn't have a fulfillment on this planet. Name one urge. Just I'll give you 30 seconds. Think of a urge that doesn't have a fulfillment on this planet. I'll give you 30 seconds. Think. Make a list. Mike will come. Okay. Lift your hand. Mike will come. Yeah, Prabhuji.
Liberation.
That's the urge. Is there a fulfillment? There is a process of bhakti. It will bring you that liberation. There is a process. Liberation means what? Getting away from birth, cycle of birth and death. Is there a process? The process is there. It's there in scriptures. You will see it provided you follow the process. You have to follow the process. I want to become thin. You go to gym, you'll become, oh, I can't see. What does it mean? Go to gym. Automatically, you'll see one day. In the same way, if you want to achieve something spiritual, you have to follow the process. Then you'll see. Prabhuji. Etuvanti korika, tirani korika emundi prapanchalo. What is the desire that cannot be fulfilled on this planet? Any normal desire. Yes, Prabhuji. Greed. Definitely it's not a positive desire. I'm talking about positive desires. They are perverted desires. Greed is perverted desire. Isn't it? See, in essence, what I'm trying to tell, every urge has a fulfillment. Every urge, you look at it. A mother, you have an urge for love. You have an urge for love. That's very natural. Is there a fulfillment? Yes. When you have children, there is so much love towards them. Your parents, you have love towards them. Your spouse, there should be love towards them. Isn't it? So every urge has a fulfillment. Natural. God has made sure that there is no urge on this planet which cannot be fulfilled. Right? Is there an urge to pray? Is it a normal urge to pray? When you are in trouble, do the hands come forward to pray? Is it a natural urge? When there is every urge that can be fulfilled, don't you think there has to be a God to fulfill the urge to pray? Does it make sense? Water is there for thirst. God is there for prayer. He exists. That is the reason that urge is there. If that urge is there, there has to be a fulfillment. It is absolutely logical. There are thousands and thousands of books written on God on the face of this planet. Do you think all of them are fools? He cannot make that statement, right? Okay, do you know a person who has seen God? Anybody here? Who actually seen God? Yeah, you know him. Can I say that there is nobody on the planet who has not seen God, so I don't believe in God? Can you say that? You cannot say that, because have you spoken to everybody? You have not spoken to everybody. Scientifically you want to answer, right? If a scientific person comes and says, Chushava Bhagavantunne? Chalamandi chusharu. Lot of people have seen. Do you know them? Have you gone and spoken to them? Obviously I cannot, because there are so many. I cannot go and find out who has seen, who has not seen. By the way, God cannot be seen. God reveals himself. No matter what tantric, mantric, meditation, chanting also you do, you cannot see God. Only when he wants to show himself, he'll show. Remember this one thing. Because a lot of pride comes even in spiritual process. People say, you will achieve nirvana, you will achieve this, you will achieve that. You will not achieve anything if God doesn't want you to achieve. That is called a bhakti. A devotee is always dependent upon God's mercy. Right? Ultimately, he has to reveal only, then only you can see him. No process on the planet can make you a claim that I can tell God, I summon you, appear in front of me. Nobody can do that. Nobody can do that. Only when he wants, he will appear. Some people pray him as son. I had gone once to, what is it, tribals in Grand Canyon. There is a Grand Canyon in America. The tribals live below, tribal families. They worship the five elements as God. Their level of understanding is that much. It's just a level of understanding. Somebody sees sun and says, sun is God. Energy is God. Light is God. But the person with the highest understanding of the energy, who is the energetic, from whom the energy is coming, that is the highest understanding of God. Who is that person? Right? Let's go forward. Creators implies, creation implies creator. Right? Do we see anything around us which is not created? Just see around. Everything is created. Somebody has created it, isn't it? It is not possible. Like, if I say that AC was not created, it just got formed by itself. Will you believe? No. There is a Lloyd factory in that the model got printed, pasted, it got created. Behind every creation, there is a creator. Isn't it? Isaac Newton, when he prepared this model, you know, he prepared a model of solar system in his house. He was a God-conscious person, Newton, even though he was a scientist. But his friends were not. His friends were like, you know, we are scientists only. We don't believe in God. Everything has to be backed up with science. So he created this model in the front room. So his friends came for supper. So they said, okay, you know, you all wait in the front room, I'll just come. And then they all saw this solar system model so nicely made. Everything moving, sun is there, planets are moving. Then after Newton came to the front room, they asked, hey, Newton, where did you get this done? Amazing model, huh? Who made it? Which factory? He said, no, I didn't make it. It just got formed. So just like that they formed. Hey, Newton, what are you saying? You know, it's clearly you can see levers. I can see the ball of planets. You would have got it done somewhere. Newton said, no. It just got formed. I throwed some metal and some balls in this room. Today morning I came, it all got formed. Then he said, Newton, you are joking with me. Then he said, you are joking with us. If you can't believe this, after all, this little model cannot be formed by itself, how do you think the whole universe is formed? Where so many planets are rotating. Everything is happening as per time. Have you seen any time sun god going on casual leave? Tomorrow morning sun will come? It will come. Nobody can stop. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, even sun is feared with me, so he rises every morning. They are all following orders. They are all following orders. Every devata is following an order. And not everybody can become sun. Who is the sun right now? What is the name of that sun? Name of sun, Prabhuji. Sun is sun. No. Sun is a designation. Name of the person in the designation right now is Vivaswan. He is the name of the person. Brahma, is it a designation or a person name? Designation. Who is the next Brahma? Hanumanji. It's already there. No need for application. Who is the next Indra? Indra is a person or a designation? Designation. Stores manager is a designation. Mr. Murthy is a person. Who is the stores manager? Indra, owner of the heavenly planets, is a designation. Who is the person? Bali Maharaj. Next application already done. Right? The whole job rotation going on. Everything is designed. All this creation is there. How is it functioning without a creator? If we can't see God, then we must really ask the question, prove that God doesn't exist. It's very difficult to prove other way around. Right? If I tell this watch got created on the sand, just shore water hit the sand and watch got created. Is there a meaning in that? No. Just the human eyeball. How many pixel can an eyeball see? So far, scientists, they have understood our human eye is 576 megapixel, somehow, some research. That also they are not sure. Did we all learn about Pluto in our... Where did it go? It's gone out of syllabus also now. Isn't it? Somebody said Newton is the smallest thing. He got a... Nobel Prize. Then after Newton, proton. Smallest, he got a Nobel Prize. Then electron, he also got a Nobel Prize. So people are discovering one by one, taking Nobel Prize and dying. What is the smallest? Where do you go and find out what is the smallest? Read Bhagavatam. It explains what is the smallest. We don't read scriptures, no? We only want to go by scientific. Science keeps changing every day. Anything that changes, is that truth? It cannot be truth. Isn't it? This beetle, the bats, they fly with radioactive signals. They don't have eyes. Bats don't have eyes. If a bat is going in this room, it will not touch a single one of these thing hanging. It will not touch us also. It will just go around without eyes. Isn't it a miracle? But there is one beetle they found out somewhere in Africa. All bats are dying in that place. Whole National Geographic ran there. What is going on? They saw, after years of research, they found out this one little beetle has the power of breaking the signals of bat. Even it doesn't know it is breaking. Wherever it is going, bats are dying. Now, US Army has taken this beetle and they are trying to understand the technology that is adopting to use it in armed forces to break the signals of enemies. Who created that beetle? Who created that bat? If we have some intelligence, we can understand. Mosquitoes. Have you seen mosquitoes running on your head anytime? How many mosquitoes? 50, 60. Have you seen one mosquito bumping into another mosquito? Any plane accident? Can you imagine what kind of pilots mosquitoes are? Not even one single Indian Airlines pilot can match the mosquito. That is the greatness of God. Isn't it? The eyes. Do you know, when the hawk comes down to get its prey, eagle, when it is coming down, the pace at which it comes down is more than 300 kilometers per hour. It's like almost a 707 jet, you know, like coming down for landing. Can you open your eyes and see at that pace? Even from your car window at 70 kilometers, you can't open your eyes. So much wind will come. It has three shutters on its eyebrows, you know that? Eagle? We have one eyebrow, right? What do you call it? Eyelid. They have three levels. One is completely transparent and no air can touch its eyeballs. No, Prabhuji, that is evolution. People say, that is evolution. Over a period of time, there was a need, so the eyelid came. What is the proof? No proof. That's just a theory. Isn't it? Theory of evolution. If there is any scientist here, I'll ask a simple question, or even if you are not a scientist. Why is the water in sea salty? If God is so intelligent, why can't he make sweet water in the sea? Khatam, no water problem, isn't it? We are dying with water problem in this country, cities, everywhere. If he just makes sweet water in the sea, all water problem is solved. Why is it salty? Salt problem. Why is it salty? Anybody? Hari Bol, what is Prabhu's name? Srinivas Prabhu. It was an excellent answer. One of the answers. Salt protects from contamination. Water doesn't get contaminated when there is salt in it. So it's a preserving element. Right? So God has a very scientific way of preserving water, which is salty. And it's easily evaporated when there is salt in the water. Water with salt can easily be evaporated. You only try. Tomorrow morning, you know, not today, it is now, it is almost rainy or winter, but in summer season, take two bowls, put same level of water, in one you put salt, keep it in sun. You will see which will evaporate first. And the clouds are easily formed and the water is transported where it is supposed to be transported. What a scientific model. Can any scientist make this? Can anybody send 1 million tankers at once? We can't get one tanker to our apartment. Sometimes we die without a tanker. God can send 1 billion tankers at once. And you know the beauty of the tanker? Aeroplane can also go in between. It will not bump into it. Tankers and tankers of water is moving in our on our head. It will go and pour that water anywhere it wants according to the plan. And it doesn't destruct anything on the way. It just crosses through mountains and it goes. What a technology. If you can't see God in this, then you are blind. Right? Such a great creation. And there are many examples like this. Big Bang Theory. Have you heard of the Big Bang Theory? How many got full marks writing answer about Big Bang Theory? We all read about Big Bang Theory. This is the biggest joke on the face of the planet, the Big Bang Theory. You know why this theory of evolution, Big Bang Theory? They actually wanted to bring down the church in the Western world. That is the reason these scientists were given money to come up with these kind of theories, and it was put forcefully into the syllabus of children so that we all will learn and start believing in it. There is nothing called Big Bang Theory. Have you blasted anything like Deepavali cracker? How many have blasted here? After blasting, what came out? Smoke and all ash everywhere, isn't it? Did you see something like this after blasting? Some beautiful scenery, waterfalls. Have you seen? So just see the Big Bang Theory. Something blasted out of nothing and everything came out of something, which is everywhere, but we don't know from where. You know, this meaningless theory out of the Big Bang. And another thing, after the Big Bang Theory came out, so many scientists rejected that. This never came in the papers. This will never be brought into the papers because the atheism has to be sent out. Na? What were the rejections? Basic rejections. See, if you keep 10 stones here and put a bomb below and you light it, bomb will blast. The 10 stones will go, isn't it? Now 10 stones have to go in one direction. Is that true? Scientists saw that one stone is going like this, stopping and going like this. It is stopping and going in a different direction. One stone is gone, coming back also. How is it possible? He asked, if universe is growing from Big Bang, how come these particles are going in different directions? They should only go in one direction. Make sense? Nobody answered that question. Nobody will answer that question. Another thing. How come the pace of the objects that are going away is increasing by each day? It should decrease, right? When the bang happens, the most powerful impact happens at that place. The speed should go 100 kilometers, 90, 80, 60, 10, 0. But now what is happening? Reverse. 10, 20, 30, 100. How come the pace is increasing? Like that, there are so many questions which scientists only have put, but all those questions are kept aside. Big Bang is in our science textbooks. 10 by 10, good, nice marks. And all of us have been brought up like atheists thinking that this universe is created out of a Big Bang. Right? When any bomb blast happens, do we investigate? When bomb blast happened in Bombay, in those trains, was there investigation? Who blasted? What kind of material was used? RDXA? What happened? Finally, did they find out? For after all, one train blast, we are doing so much investigation. Our entire existence is kept on Big Bang. How many people investigated whether this Big Bang happened? Who blasted? How did it blast? No investigation. No investigation. The biggest of the facts are simply thrown onto us. No investigation. Government deputed a special inquiry. But in case of Big Bang, is there any inquiry deputed? Nothing. See, I'll tell you, children, just imagine children, when they are brought up in godless civilization, telling that with Big Bang you got created, what faith will you have in God? Zero faith. Lord Krishna declares in Bhagavad Gita who is the creator. Now I am telling the fact from scripture itself. Right? Aham sarvasva prabhavo matta sarvam pravartate iti matva bhujante mam buddha bhava samanvita. What is he saying? I am the source of all spiritual and material worlds. Everything emanates from me. The wise who perfectly know this engage in my devotional service and worship me with all their hearts. Is this a bold statement? Can anybody make this statement? I can tell you, go and read if you have time, any Purana, any Upanishad, anywhere in the Vedas. Nobody has the audacity to make the statement that Lord Krishna has made. Even Lord Shiva will not make this statement. I am the creator of everything. See, read Shiva Purana, I have read. Nowhere he'll say this thing. Only one person can make this statement. The one who created it. And who has agreed to this? Ganesh ji. Only then he wrote it, na? Isn't it? These statements are very, Aham Sarvasva Prabhavo, I am the creator of everything, both spiritual, material, everything I have created. Everything emanates from me. You are ready to accept a Big Bang theory, you are ready to accept a Big Bang theory without any proof, why can't you accept this statement? No, Prabhuji, you know, this is scripture, you know, we need science. Arey Baba, this is not science. Let me tell you, who was the one who invented gravity? Discovered rather? Gravity. Who saw the apple? Newton. Newton saw an apple falling down. So what did he see apart from the apple? If it was I would have just eaten that apple. But Newton saw something more. He said, why is this falling down? So there has to be an invisible principle. A principle that is there in the nature which is invisible, but I want to know what that principle is. Understood? Out of that principle took birth of gravity. Science also is based on invisible principles. All the principles of science are invisible only. Pendulum, the principle of, you know, it going from one direction. Can you see it? The principle is there, that an object that goes till here comes back till here. That's a principle. There is a law somewhere in the background. You can't see it, but you accept it. You put a name to it. Science also is based on invisible principles. And based on that principles, you do experiments to prove the existence of those principles. Making sense? Tomorrow when you are challenged, just tell, what did your science take birth from? Can you show gravity? Give me 20 grams gravity, I'll keep it. No, gravity exists. Right, show it to me. No, throw this thing. No, don't throw it. Just show it to me. I want to touch gravity. Scientific only, right? Scientist means I have to touch. Let me touch gravity. They can't touch gravity. Law of cause and effect. Every action will have equivalent opposite reaction. Now, can I touch this principle? I cannot. Does it happen? It happens. So science is also based on invisible principles. So is spirituality. Spirituality also is based on invisible principles. When I say chant 16 rounds every day, after 6 months you'll be a different person. Prabhuji, this I'll not believe. Why don't you believe? It's invisible principle. I'm telling you the process. You follow the process, then you'll see what happens. After you chant holy names every single day for 16 rounds, every single day for 6 months, you will be a different person. A different consciousness will arise out of you. No, this I'm not ready to. This is all because of this bombardment of this materialistic knowledge that we have been given in schools. Right? Spirituality also. There are so many laws. Law of vibration, law of relativity, law of polarity, law of cause and effect. All these laws, who made? You have a question?
So, Lord Krishna says that he created everything.
Yeah.
Does that mean that he created our souls as well?
Yes. He says, Aham Bija Pradapita.
So, if he created our souls, then he has put us in this endless cycle?
Yes.
To follow it and go back to nothing.
Very nice. Very nice question. What is your name?
Harsha.
Harsha, very nice question. Amazing, you know, fearlessly asked this question. If God has created us all, why did he create this material world and throw us into this? One correction, it's not endless. If it is endless, then we should not be sitting here. Right? There is a hope. See, a child is saying, Nana, I want to go and play on the road. What does the father say? Nana, play in the house. Don't play on the road. No, Nana, I want to play on the road. No, Nana, play in the house. Nana! Ksh, he started crying. What will Nana do? No, he's not understanding. Baba, don't go and play on that place. It's dangerous. Don't need to go there. No, Nana, I want to play on the road. Intelligent father, what he'll do? He will tell his friend. He'll call his friend. Nana, come here. I will send my son outside. You come slowly on a bicycle. When he's playing, just little bump you give him. He'll fall. Right? So that person will come. He'll slowly give a little bump. And this child will fall. Nana, I got it. Then he said, Chepyan gara, internet. Better play in the house. Because if you play outside, you can get an accident. Right? What did that father do? He created a controlled environment to teach a lesson to his child. That controlled environment is this world. It's not endless. Everything God is controlling, keeping us here so that we can learn actually that we don't belong here. That we are actually, soul doesn't have anything called death, which I'll discuss in the next sessions. When I discuss who am I, your answers will be more rigid. But I appreciate your question. Did I answer that part of your question at least? Why God has created, why has he put us here? He has put us here because we need a lesson. And we are the ones who actually wanted to come here. The child did not, father did not want him to come on the road. We are the ones who told, I want to go and play on the road. Krishna told, no, don't go. Why you want to go? Nicely in the house. I'll put AC. Stay in the house. No, I want to go outside and play. Okay, play. But you will learn a lesson. You will learn such a lesson that you will not go out again. Right? But I really appreciate your question. No, there will be more such questions that will come as we go into the next topics. Okay? We have a problem in accepting God as a person. What is the problem in accepting God as a person? Normally people say God is Nirakara, Nirguna, and what else? Like that. Why? What is the problem in accepting God as a person? I'll tell you one of the myths that people carry. That when something doesn't have a shape, it is unlimited. When something has a shape, it's limited. That is our materialistic way of thinking. Make sense? When something has a shape. For example, is this room limited? Limited or no? It's limited. If I blast this room into powder, does it become unlimited? It is still limited. Just that the shape is different. It is completely into powder. In the same way, just because Brahman or light and effulgence looks endless, doesn't mean God is greater than as compared to a person. I'll talk about Brahman understanding versus Bhagavan understanding, impersonal understanding versus personal understanding, Nirakara understanding versus Nirguna understanding in the 10th session. That's an advanced topic. I will guarantee clarify all your doubts with verses. That's a big topic in itself, especially in India. A lot of people are bombarded. I don't want to name those institutions who have completely bombarded that, you know, it is God is Nirakara, Nirguna, there is nothing. They also worship the idols. There is a big khichdi there. But we will only follow the scriptures. If somebody here wants to back up those arguments, bring your scriptures also. And I will bring my scriptures also. That's why it will be a little longer session, 10th session. Okay? But what is the problem in accepting God as a person? I'll tell you what is the problem. If you are doing some notorious activities on the floor, on the office floor, if somebody says, organization will punish you, I say, punish karne do. Organization. Organization is impersonal. There is nothing. But if you tell, Mr. Murthy will punish you, Murthy kidare? Immediately you will become more responsible. Why? Murthy exists. Murthy is in control of situation. But organization is very general. Are you following me? Another thing. If you say God likes you to do this like this, it's very general. But if you say Krishna doesn't like you to do this, very specific. The moment you say God is a person has likes and dislikes also. Is that true? People want a God who will like them whatever they do. That's not God. But the moment God has a name and God becomes a person, God will tell, this is what I like, this is what I don't like. How many have read 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita? 12th chapter. Okay. Please read again attentively today. You will exactly see what Krishna tells, I like and I don't like. 12, 13, 14, direct he starts. So, accepting God as a person becomes a problem. Yes, Prabhuji.
God has power, right?
Yes. Yes.
So the problem with the human being is mind.
Yes.
Why can't we purify it so that now we don't have that many kind of problems in the
day-to-day life? Raju Prabhu, right? Yes. So Prabhuji's question is, God has power. God also knows that our mind is a problem. Why can't he apply his power and purify? Okay. If I tie all of you to these chairs and finish 12 sessions, you'll all become knowledgeable. Will you like it? Or do you want to come on your choice? Will you learn on your choice or will you learn when I force you to learn? Choice, isn't it? That's the reason God doesn't apply his power. Because we are also having the same quality of God. Swarat, God is Swarat, independent. And he has also given that independence to us. And God wants us to choose him. Because that is when love comes. Love comes when there is no pressure. When there is no force. Because when somebody starts loving you, then you don't need to worry. Because after love, then nothing can go wrong. But if you force somebody to come towards you, sooner or later again we'll run away. So God, what he does, Krishna, he gives Bhagavad Gita and then he gives sampradayas. So go and tell this Bhagavad Gita to everybody in the world. And he'll also be there always, sitting in our heart. There are three Vishnus, Karanadakshya Vishnu, Garbhodakshya Vishnu, Kshirodakshya Vishnu, which is advanced topic, but one Vishnu is sitting inside us as Paramatma. He is always monitoring us and he is always guiding us. That how many felt you heard an inner voice when you are doing something wrong? When you are doing something wrong, oddu, cheyaku, no, don't do this. It comes, but still you do it because you are angry or something like that. That inner voice is who? That Kshirodakshya Vishnu. He is telling you, don't do this. You will become more far away from me. Right? That voice is nothing but God's voice. He is there with us. He keeps on guiding. But he wants us to choose. In spite of telling the whole Bhagavad Gita, at the end Krishna says to Arjuna, I have told you everything, Partha. If you want, I will tell it again. If you have any clarifications, I am ready to give it to you. But choice is yours. You decide whether you want to do the war or not. Right? Because when we choose to do something after understanding, we will live by that decision. For example, if we tell our children, do sandhya, do sandhya, do sandhya, do sandhya, one day after some time they'll stop doing sandhya. But if you motivate them to do sandhya and they are only doing sandhya with their own motivation, nobody can stop them from doing sandhya, isn't it? That is how God also treats. So this limitless thing I explained. Another thing is that a boss, the moment you accept him as a person, then you are responsible to accept by his wills and desires. Yeah. Who is God session, you'll get more. Law implies a lawmaker. Now we'll go fast. Law is a lawmaker. Now, you're seeing so many laws around, right? There should be a lawmaker. Without this lawmaker, like so many signals are there. Are these signals being tuned through some kind of a program? Yes. Without that, it cannot function. And what happens if the signals stop working tomorrow morning? All the signals in Hyderabad? Finished. Nobody can go out of their houses. Isn't it? There are so many laws. This train in Japan, they told our train is flawless. We have put all the combinations. And what is the result of that? After some time, huge accident happened. Hundreds of people died. Because one combination even they could not estimate. Without human intervention, nothing can function. Right? Every law requires a lawmaker. So if there are so many laws, there are so many laws on this planet. Like this law of nature. What is the law of nature? You will look young. What is that? Dehi nosmini kaumaram yavvanam jara. Krishna says, Dehi nosmini yata dehe kaumaram yavvanam jara. You'll be a small child, infant, then yavvanam, youth, then jara. Meaning old age. Can anybody change this law? Can anybody go reverse? You cannot go. That means there is a law. Who made this law? And it is not only for animals or humans, everything, birds, even they have to go through this cycle. Anything on this planet have to go through the cycle. Just see how it is happening. We can identify somewhere we are. I think I am somewhere here. In some years, I'll be here. Somebody is already here. Maybe all of us are here. You don't know, isn't it? When death will come. So there is embryo, there is a baby, there is a child, teen, adult, aging. Again, we become egg. Right? The cycle never stops. So when there is a law, there is a lawmaker. Most intelligent can see the creator. Even scientists have come to a conclusion that there is a creator behind this creation. You see this. Anyway, it will be on YouTube. You can pause it and read the whole thing. It says, it is impossible to explain the perfect balance in which the earth is situated right now. It is impossible. If I change even 1.0001 somewhere, we all will be in liquid. We all will be underwater. Such a great balance. How is it possible? Now you cannot tell this is evolution. People say we evolved from monkeys. Come on, please raise your hand if you are really convinced on this. Have we all come from monkeys? I might look like a monkey, but I am sure you don't look like a monkey. Just if we all came from monkeys, then how come there are still some monkeys left out? They forgot to become human? Even Darwin theory of evolution doesn't have any basis. There is no basis for that. We are evolving. A donkey will become horse. Will donkey become horse? Nothing like that. Bhagavad Gita already says 8.4 million species are there. 2 million types of plants, 4 million types of insects. It's all numbers, including numbers. 400,000 types of humans. Types of humans, Prabhuji. Kya bol rahe? Matlab, how many types are we? We'll get into the topic later. Right? Everything is already there. In Ramayana, it is explained when Hanumanji comes, Kim Nara has come. It says, Kim Nara. Hanumanji is not a monkey, I'm sorry to tell. Hanumanji is not a monkey. Hanumanji belongs to a creed called Kim Nara. Can you all say? Kim Nara. Kim means what? Is it? Nara, human? Is he human? Kim Nara? He's a different species, type of species among 8.4 million. Where he looks like a human, but he appears like certain features of a monkey. So is it tomorrow? Hanumanji is a monkey. Monkey ki puja karte ho? Nahi, monkey ki puja nahi karte. We don't worship monkeys. We worship Hanumanji, who is a great devotee of Lord Ram, who is more powerful than anybody that we can see. Isn't it? One leg of Hanumanji, they could not move. Ravan was scared to death by one appearance of Hanumanji. Hanumanji could have finished Ravan there itself. Ramayana would have been 50% less verses. But Hanumanji felt, no. This fellow, he needs to be punished and killed. Because he dared to look at Mother Sita. My Hanumanji, my Prabhu will come and take care of this fellow. There is all bhakti involved why those decisions were made. So such a perfect balance. Look at these scientists, greatest of scientists in the past. Albert Einstein. The more I study science, the more I believe in God. Such a beautiful statement, Albert Einstein. People say science is against God. No, now it is against God. Now we are becoming stupid. But earlier, the greatest of the scientists, look at this. Louis Pasteur is saying, a bit of science distances one from God, but much science nears one to him. The more I study nature and the more I stand amazed at the work of the Creator. Amazing statement. One scientist told, just hear these words attentively. One scientist told, in science, God comes at the end. In science, God comes at the end. In religion, God comes in the beginning. That's the only difference. You keep on beating your head. At the last, you will go to that point. Bhagwani hoga. But in religion, we already accept Bhagwani hai. Then we start our life from there. Right? Here is a proof that who is running this world. 9.10 Mayadhikshena prakriti suyate sa characharam hetunanena kaunteya jagad viparivartate. Who is prakriti? Durga. Who is controlling Durga? See what Krishna. Mayadhikshena prakriti. According to my order, Durga is functioning. Prakriti is functioning. This material nature, which is one of my energies, see the Krishna statement, is working under my direction. O son of Kunti, producing all moving and non-moving beings. Under its rule, this manifestation is created and annihilated again and again and again. This material world is not mithya. Again, there is another philosophy. Jagan mithya, jagat mithya. They say everything is illusion, everything is false. No, it's not false. It's true, but it's temporary. There is a difference. It's true. If I bang this to my head, it will bleed. It is true. It exists. But it's temporary. Material world is true. It exists. But it's temporary. What is the proof of temporary? He is telling. Is annihilated again and again and again. It comes and it goes. Comes and goes. Following me? Next. Prakrite kriyamanani gune karmani sarvasha ahankara vimudatma karta hamiti manyate. Krishna is telling. Second chapter. Third chapter. What does it mean? He's saying the bewildered spirit soul under the influence of three modes of material nature thinks himself to the doer of all activities which is actually carried out by the nature. This is a little advanced verse, but please don't miss the session of three modes of material nature. Three modes of material nature is the fourth session. Very technical, very important. If you miss that one session, your whole foundation is shaken. What is sattvaguna? What is rajoguna? What is tamoguna? And how it is there across? Entire planet, whole material world is being run by these three gunas. We don't know what it is. Bhagavad Gita, more than 50% of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is talking about these three gunas. Lot of people don't know this. What are these three gunas? What is sattva? What is raja? What is tamas? Which Purana is in tamaguna? It's dealing with tamaguna. Which scripture is dealing with sattva guna? There is a whole science behind it. Don't miss it. For you who are going through these sessions, 12 sessions, every single session is so integrally tied into the whole, you know, solution that if you miss one, it's very difficult to make you understand. Especially the third and the fourth are like very, very important. What is the third? It's proof of scriptures. Then only you will have faith on scriptures. Next, modes of material nature. Right? Very, very important. Don't miss that. Definition of God. Now, what is the definition of God? God means, people have different definitions of God. You know, I'll tell this example. You know, one person, he became very thirsty. He was looking for water. Then he saw a watermelon. He took that watermelon. He ate the watermelon. His thirst went away. Then he looked at that watermelon. He said, hey, this big watermelon, such a thin creeper. What kind of a God is? Big fruit means big tree. This much logic also God doesn't have. Then he drank that water. Then he went and slept under a tree. Big tree. Small nut fell from the top on his head. He got up. Hey, what is this? He saw a small nut. Then he imagined. Had it been watermelon? So don't try to judge God with your rational. With your little, you know, 50 grams of grey matter in that head. Don't think you can understand the creation of God. He knows much more than us. Why, what is, how? He knows. Right? So definition of God. According to me, is the biggest disease of modern Indians. Or rather modern people. I will define what is God. According to me, Prabhuji, who cares you are according to me? First, why don't you learn what is there in the scripture? Why don't you learn who is God? Can somebody prove this is not gold? This here, this mic. Can you all see? How do you prove this is not gold? Color. And? How can I bend? So there is a criteria, right? There is a criteria to decide this is gold or not. Isn't it? What is the criteria for you to decide who is God? Prabhuji, that is not... I should feeling. There is a feeling. Whenever I see him, I feel like I am seeing God. Is that a criteria? Whenever I see this, I feel it's gold. What will people call me? Fool. Isn't it? Whenever I see this, Prabhuji, is gold only. No, you don't know what is gold. That is the problem. When you don't know what is gold, you can decide anything is gold. When you don't know who is God, you will decide anybody as God. That is your problem. Make sense? First to know who is God. Material knowledge goes from bottom to top. Spiritual knowledge comes from top to bottom. That is the difference. You can seek. Some people say, Prabhuji, I am seeking about God. Seeking. I am a seeker. Nothing will come after your seeking. Nothing will come out. Because unless God reveals it from top to bottom, you cannot understand anything. Lot of people left their families, you know, left their homes in the name of seeking. They left their wife, children, and went, you know, and they carried six wives with them. Anger, pride, lust, greed, all their wives only. Right? Nothing they achieved. One person, he was climbing some hill, you know, some hill station he was going, some pilgrimage. And on the way, he saw a nice rock. He said, I'll take a picture here. So, went and stood there. Somebody else was taking a click. Suddenly, one big, you know, rishi with big dadi and one langot, he started, hey, that is my place of tapasya. Get out from there. That is my place. So, this the fellow was thinking, you left your home, wife, everything and got attached to that stone. What is that detachment you have? Huh? So, real detachment is here. You don't need to leave anything. You can still work your job. You can still take care of your family. Do everything, but become God conscious. Understand who is God. Definition of God, very, very important. There are two things that are infinite. The universe and human stupidity. These two things are. And he is saying, I am not sure on the first one, but second one is pakka. Human stupidity, there is limitless. So, God is the source of everything. When somebody says that I am God, he has to be the source of everything. Remember this. Source of everything. Everything. Not that he is sitting somewhere in the city and is calling himself as God. What is that fellow's name? I'm sorry. Sometimes it comes out. Kalki. There are so many Kalkis in India now. One Kalki sitting in Tamil Nadu. In Bhagawan. His wife is sitting. Amma. Are they the source of everything? Is that fellow the source of this hall right now? Can he control what we are doing here? Can he control? No. Then how can I declare he is God? He cannot declare he is God. Right? He has to be the source of everything. Ishwaraha Paramaha Krishna Satchitananda Ishwaraha Paramaha Krishna Satchitananda Vigraha Anadiradir Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. Sarva Karana Karanam. Scripture say he has to be the cause of all causes. Then only is God. Don't try to declare any Eragara is God. Right? Next. What is the next definition? He has to be the controller of everything. He should control everything. Is president in control of everything? Can Narendra Modi control everything? No. Can he control the satsang? No. Can Krishna control the satsang? Yes. He can control any time, in any situation. Then he is God. Okay. He has to be the proprietor of everything. He is the owner of everything. Nobody can claim that I am also the owner, side by side owner. Can you say? Our own houses, we don't know whether we're owners or not. For that matter, can we say this country is ours? Earlier, our country used to look like this. Now it became like this. God knows after which war how it will become. For that matter, is our body ours? This very body that you are thinking is yours. Is this yours? It can be snatched out of you like this. Tomorrow morning, you have no relationship with this body. It is possible. But Krishna, he is the controller, he is the proprietor of everything. Everything. Right? Fourth, enjoyer. What is the first one? Definition of God. What is the first one? He is the source of everything. Next, controller of everything. Third, proprietor of everything. Fourth, enjoyer of everything. The most important definition is the fourth definition. Krishna is the enjoyer of everything. Right? God doesn't mean he has to work. If God is also working, there is a big problem. God doesn't need to work. God just expands into people who can do that creation for him, destruction for him, and maintenance for him. You see this Gokul Chat. How many have gone to Gokul Chat? In Koti? Yeah? Nice, right? Anyway, in my college days I used to go. There, once I went to Gokul Chat, in the night I saw, whole day everybody is working. So, you know, to make the chart, everything. Night, 11 o'clock, when Marathi van fellow came, big tummy like this, pyjama penke, came, took all that cash, put it into the Marathi van, closed the dicky and went. He is the enjoyer. All these people are working. God is that. God is only the enjoyer. Krishna is the enjoyer. Vishnu, Shiva, Brahma, they're all working for different purposes. This is the highest understanding. We will get to that with scriptural reference when we go into the 10th session. I'm just giving a glimpse. We're not blindly believing. We'll quote with scriptures, with examples, with full understanding. Why? Why do you say when any yajna starts, at the end what do you say? Krishna Arpanamastu. Ultimately, whether you do Ganesh Puja, whether you do Shiv Puja, any Puja you do, at the end, Vasudeva Samarpayami. It has to end there. In between you can have anything. Right? All the Vedic scriptures, we have to understand that God is not working. If God is also working, there is a big problem. God is the enjoyer of everything. The highest definition of God is, He is the enjoyer of everything. Right? Bhoktaram Yagyatapusam Sarva Loka Maheshwaram. He is the Bhokta of everything. If everybody is working, who is enjoying? He is the one who is enjoying. This entire creation is for His enjoyment. That is the highest understanding of Vedas. May not be easy for us to accept right now. But if you chant for 6 months and read the scriptures regularly, you will one day come to that conclusion. He will reveal it. That actually everything is for His enjoyment only. There is no other reason for this whole existence to happen. So what is the definition? What is the proof of enjoyment? He has to be the proprietor. What is the proof of proprietorship? He has to be the controller. Proof of controllership, he has to be the creator. Proof of creation, he has to be the cause of all causes. Sarva karana karana. Then only you can say he is a creator. Prabhupada told, if anybody is claiming that he is G-O-D, God, then he is exactly the opposite. D-O-G, dog. That's all he is. Nobody can claim that he is G-O-D, God. God is a very, very special word to be used. Unfortunately, people write on that, what is it, magazines or that, on the hoarding, Bhagavantullanti ma leader, like that they write. That word Bhagavan is so cheaply used. No, we should know the meaning of these words. In Shastra, it is not. In Bhagavad Gita, only when Krishna speaks, it comes, it doesn't say Krishna Vacha. What does it say? Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Bhagavan Vacha is not used for anybody else. Arjuna Vacha. Sanjay Vacha, Dhritarashtra Vacha, Bhagavan Vacha. Never. if somebody, this is just for fun at the end. If somebody is trying to say he is God, you can test him in 3 ways. Difficult test, medium test, simple test. Children will like it. What is a difficult test? If somebody is saying, I am Bhagavantunandi, I am Bhagavantunni. How will you test? Difficult test. Ask him to lift Govardhan. On his pinky finger, ask him to lift 25 square miles Govardhan Parvat. What Govardhan? He can't lift this laptop for 5 minutes on pinky finger. Right? What other test you want to put? There are many like that. Stop the sun from rising. Show the universe in his mouth. At the most, he can show all cavity. He cannot show anything more than that. What are the moderate tests? Read entire Bhagavatam non-stop. The same Shastra that you gave, read it without non-stop. Sutta Goswami, who heard from Sukadeva Goswami, repeated entire 18,000 verses non-stop because he is a devotee of Krishna. In Naima Sharanya, he repeated entire Bhagavatam. But no ordinary person can do that. Okay, simple test. What are the simple tests? Ask him to drink 4 liters of water and sit here without moving for two hours. Enough. Are the person who claimed himself as Bhagavan died in a ICU, he could not even control his grey hair from falling. And people still say he is a Bhagavan, Bhagavan, Bhagavan. There are so many Bhagavans like that. Because we don't know the meaning of God. That is a problem. We don't know the meaning of God. Who is God? We don't know. That is a problem. We should know first of all who is God. Then we can declare who is God. Right? After attending all these sessions, you will definitely get answers to these questions that I put in the beginning. Right? These sessions, the faith on does God exist has to come from within you. Don't believe it whimsically. Right? And let us behave in our lives understanding that God exists. Automatically, all the right things will happen in our life. We will never do wrong things in life. Today, why people are going against law? Because they don't have faith on the lawmaker. That is a problem. They don't actually believe in God. They just unta unnadu devudu. So many people, so many bad things they are doing. You know, I recently heard somebody was removing the expiry date on medicines and rewriting it so that they can sell the medicines. Can you imagine? Which human will do something like that? Because they don't know. They don't have faith in. And that fellow will also go to temple. Just imagine somebody who is writing Darwin theory in exam goes to temple in the morning saying, please pass me in the exam. What a contradiction. Darwin says there is no God, and to write that thing, he is going to temple and worshipping that I should get good marks. That is our situation. We don't know what we are doing. But all the children here, please write your exam. We still need those marks. Right? I'm sorry, it was a little long session. Does God exist? It's something that you all have to contemplate. Just hearing me is not enough. But you have to see your own life and see where all God has intervened. I can tell you one place where God has intervened is these sessions itself. How many planned in 2017 that you will attend something like Science of Self-Realization in 2019? Did anybody plan here? Nobody planned. How many planned that one day you will start chanting Hare Krishna? Nobody planned. He is planning everything for us. The only contribution that we can do is don't become an obstacle in his plans. Allow this to happen. And my humble request is also, we all will be tested. We all will be tested. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'll tell. Yeah, I'll tell. Thank you, Praveen. Praveen Prabhu always reminds me of everything I forget. Yeah. What did I say? Yeah, we all will be tested. We all will be tested of one thing, I'll tell you, Prabhu and Mataji. Not that I'm mesmerizing or hypnotizing you. When you want to come to these sessions, Maya will test you. Some relative will crop in your house. Some new assignment will come your way. Right? Some situation will come in the house and you have to decide whether I have to go to this or no. Trust me, these are all tests only. The moment you show a desire, strong desire that I have to come to these sessions, I want to learn about you, Krishna, automatically God also will help you. I've seen that personally in my life. If relatives are coming, ask those relatives to come here. They'll automatically run away. Okay? Nothing is more important than self-realization, because death is standing right behind us. We don't know whether this is the last session or the first session. We don't know. Right? Maybe second session of SSR is all. I might die. Who knows? Right? So take it very seriously. This is a divine intervention. Take it very seriously. Learn these things. It's not entertainment. There is a great deal of sacrifice that is happening here. I'm not doing any sacrifice, but those people standing behind the organizing committee here, they're all sacrificing their evenings, money, rest, everything they're sacrificing. So all of you can listen. You only have to sacrifice one choice. Right? Be regular, come on time. The later you come, the more you miss, and the less you will be motivated to give. When I see everybody sitting, I feel like telling everything. When I see only few sitting, then I keep thinking, maybe I should not tell everything now. Maybe I should tell later when others will come. Right? Next 12 weeks are yours. Navratri is coming. A great time of Ganesh Puja just passed by. All auspicious timing is coming. Let's use that auspicious timing in learning about God. Isn't it? And small announcement, one on the books. There is Nilesh Prabhu. Can you please stand up, Prabhu? You can see. Prabhuji has been working in Oracle for more than a decade, but he does an amazing work. What he does is he gets these books from Delhi. It's called Values of Life. They are for children. Each book is, I don't know, 200 rupees, something like that. Maybe Prabhuji will tell the price. But they are a set, part 1, part 2, part 3. What is the nice thing about these books? Is they have exercises, you can see, summary, fill in the blanks, chapter. So a way in which the child himself can learn. I bought many of these books and kept in my house, because whenever there is a birthday party, instead of buying something plastic, I give this. 200 rupees, a very beautiful gift, which any child, right from the age of 4 to 12, or even later, can read these books. Both my sons have finished these entire books without even my help. And let me tell you, when I read these books, I felt I have learnt a lot. Because they deal with all these topics. And topics like why I should respect elders, why I should be peaceful, why I should be obedient. How much can you explain? Why I should be obedient, how much can you explain? But in this book, you'll have 8-9 examples with 8-9 stories why one has to be obedient. I'll tell, this is a treasure that you all should carry back home. I have requested Prabhuji to get some, I don't know how many he got, but he has some stock there. So please take these. You know, there is effort he has taken to bring. And we are not getting any commission out of this, please. This is only to benefit you and your families. And something more. We have some of these books. Is a Bhagavad Gita as it is. This should be worshipped but also read. So we have this book available right at the counter. We got it for all of you. Every single person should have his own individual Bhagavad Gita. The simple reason is it's a personal copy. It's not a family subscription. In this Bhagavad Gita, you will write your notes, you will underline the statements, you will actually make this a book of your life. And you have to carry in your office bag wherever you go. Right? So make this part of your life. Any time in the day, you're in a flight or in a bus or in a metro, you can read some part of Bhagavad Gita. So please take your copy. We got it from the temple. Again, as I said, it's just as a exercise of making it available for you. We got a lot of stock, and every time taking it back also is, you know, an effort. So since they are here, if you don't have, please take one. You want to gift somebody, our Prime Minister has gifted to the whole world. With pride I can tell. Isse badke aur kya hai? Kuch bhi nahi hai. Right? So Bhagavad Gita is there. Easily readable Ramayana. Ramayana is more than 1 lakh verses. But His Holiness Bhaktivikas Maharaj, beautifully, he wrote the story of Ramayana. Like a story. You might say, I already have Ramayana, but still, what is the harm in reading one more explanation in simple words? So this is a nice copy. And these are two very wonderful books. The Journey Home, Part 1, and Journey Within, Part 2. Journey, how many have read this book here? Anybody? Did you like this book? It's like a novel, right? When you read this book, it's like a novel. It's like, it just takes some, one 19-year-old boy's journey. Enter. Is it, Madhuri? Amazing. When I read this book, it's amazing. It's like a 19-year-old boy hitchhiking from Europe to India in 1969. He went through all Middle Eastern countries. The whole map of where all he went is there, you know, in this book. Who all he met, what all religions he saw on the way, people that he met. He met Mother Teresa, he met Neem Karoli Baba, and God not. Finally, he met Srila Prabhupada, right? It's a beautiful journey. If you go to YouTube and say The Journey Home, you'll be shocked to see 1,000 videos on this feedback. So we made it available. It's not very expensive. And this is a world acclaimed second part of that, but it's not linked. Don't think that you need to read that to read this. Actually, this book was written first by His Holiness Radhanath Swami. The amazing part of this, it's a New York Times bestseller. Not every book gets New York Times bestseller. Because he explained the entire science of celebration, what we are doing, with examples. So you want to hear with examples, you can take this book. Actually, this is a hardbound copy, which is for $25 on Amazon. But one of my friends, when I told that I preach, what he does in from US, he sends me these books. Whenever somebody comes, he gets in, you know, like in suitcases. So I can give it at a price and use these funds to run these sessions. So we kept a price tag of only 700 rupees. I can bet you nowhere you'll find it for 700. Because price tag itself is $25 here. So you can take these books. We have very limited, because I don't know, maybe 15 or 20 I have. But that much only he sent this year. So you can grab one of these books, very useful book, with example, simple words, and Journey Home. Right? I would recommend these two, and also The Values of Life for Children and Friends. Basically, I'm recommending everything. Okay, so one very important announcement, last one, is that we are planning to change the venue, because I've heard from DCS, you know, the DCS servants who are working with you. They told that, you know, so for some of you, parking is becoming very difficult here. And of course, the air circulation is a little humid. So we have been looking for options. We always kept options. Though my first preference is this place. Because it is a devotee's place. His name is Krishna Kumar Prabhu. He teaches yoga here. But I am also concerned about your comfort. So there is another place called Green Grace Apartments. How many here know Nanakram Guda? How many know Gachibowli Flyover? Yeah, little far from there. We'll send you the map, right? It's not too far from here. The best thing there is unlimited parking. You can get 5 cars for 5 people in the family. No problem. And it's AC hall. And we also have been given some storage space. And the community has actually given it for almost free price, saying they want the Bhagavad Gita sessions to be conducted. And Subbarao Prabhu, who actually is the India head for Aztec Technologies, very high post. So he personally worked on it, trying to get some option, right? We might again come back here, we might go, but I'm just trying to make sure. How many here come by public commute? Please lift your hand. Okay. So if it's a little challenging for you, because Nanakram Guda, your choices might be a little less, but you can come till Gachibowli flyover and then take a shared auto which comes to Nanakram Guda Chaurasta. That's the easiest way to come there. And Green Gates Apartments. Right? Yeah. Is that okay? So next week, I'll send the Google Maps. I would like to thank Krishna Kumar Prabhu for hosting the program here. I wish if it had been a little lesser group, it would have been much easier here. But I don't know, Prabhuji, please forgive me and allow me to, whatever Krishna's mercy. But I'm sure more sessions will happen here. Prabhuji has a desire that this place should become more and more spiritual. Yoga means to unite soul with super soul. And that's what should be happening in this yoga studio. That's what we are doing. So next week we'll change the venue. Please everybody come. And if you face any problems, please speak to your devotee care servants, or you have my number. You can anytime message me or call me. I'm your servant. I'm more than happy to guide you, help you in whichever way. But before going, please take these books. It helps us actually finance this event also. It is not self-financed or anything. We all raise money. One Mataji has sponsored, I heard, dinner for today evening. Is she here? Yeah. Even if she is not here, let's say three loud Hari Bowls for her. Hari Bowl! Hari Bowl! Hari Bowl! Yeah. I mean, anything. For Lord Ram, he saw the same capacity in Hanuman. He saw the same capacity in a spider. Whatever we do for devotion, it might be 50 paisa, it might be just our effort. I appreciate Vishal Prabhu coming here today early, and he was setting up the place. He was helping us put all these chairs that you're sitting right now. And so many other people are coming. I mean, it's a voluntary event, right? So if you want to help us set up the place, you can also come 15 minutes early and you will see everything is a chaos. When you come, everything looks organized, but we try to put things together. So please help us conduct this. And I would like to seek your forgiveness if I have spoken anything harshly, wrongly, incorrectly. If I have spoken anything correct today, that's only because of the mercy of my Guru. And if I have spoken anything wrong, which I am sure I would have, it's only because of my own ego, which I have to correct myself. So I am deeply appreciative for all of you coming here. Children are waiting to do Narsingh Aarti. Is it true? Okay, chalo aajao. So Narsingh Aarti will do, yes. Somebody has any question? Okay.
So the only question whenever I'm reading something is that Nityananda, whenever he comes, I get that person into my mind. So I need just a small explanation. So what does Nityananda in this mean and why is that coming?
Oh, why, what is Nityananda in our verse?
Yes.
We chant Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda. Nityananda is Swayam Lord Balram. When he appears in the age of Kali, he comes, Balramji himself comes as Lord Nityananda. And he is the most merciful avatar, because you know how Nityananda Prabhu preaches? Not this Nityananda. I'm talking about Balramji when he preaches. He comes to your house, begs, falling at your feet, please chant Hare Krishna. That is the mood of God. God is not God. He is more like a servant, right? So I'm sure by attending these 12 sessions, the whole ghost of that Nityananda will go away and the real Nityananda will come to your house. Hare Krishna. Don't worry. You know, there are so many jokers on this planet. You know, so unfortunately 90% are in spiritual circles. Right? And we have to face them and deal with them, and somehow Krishna has to help us. Prabhus, I'll leave you with one thought. Okay? I don't know tomorrow you'll come or not, I'll be there or not. How will you check whether you're being cheated or not? There is three pramans, three validations. Remember this: Guru, Shastra, Sadhu. Repeat after me: Guru, Shastra, Sadhu. Guru has to be in parampara, and he has to tell whatever I'm speaking is right. There has to be a Shastra praman. There has to be a verse in the scriptures. Sadhu, meaning other paramparas also have to accept this. Whatever I say, even Chinnajir Swami has to accept it. Not that, you know, I am speaking something because I am following some parampara and some other parampara is not accepting it. No, it never happens like that. All the paramparas that are there, they all will accept. So, Guru, Shastra, Sadhu. If you remember these three things, you can never be cheated. You can never be cheated by anybody. But wherever you are going, if that person doesn't have either Guru in parampara other sampradayas are not accepting, and he has no scripture to refer to, I'm sorry, guaranteed you are being cheated. Right? So that much we can tell. So I cannot hold them more. We will, So the next session is spiritual knowledge, scriptures. Please don't miss it. This is Narsing Aarti. We sing Narsing Aarti for only one reason. You see, the plant of bhakti is so small. Bhakti Lata Beej, we say. So small, very tender. Even a little force on it can kill it. Our bhakti in our heart is also like that. It has to be watered, it has to be taken care, slowly. Right? 12 sessions, it should last. And after that, it should last for Bhagavad Gita. Then Bhagavatam. Right? So we need Lord Narsing Dev's blessings. Lord Narsing Dev came to save Prahlad. In the same way, in this kirtan, we chant at the end of satsang, every satsang, that hey Narsing Dev, please come and save this little seed of devotion I have in my heart. I have come here to learn about you. Please allow me to come and please remove all the obstacles. Right? So without any delay, Madhav Prabhu, this boy is chanting since the, this kirtan since he was 2 years old or maybe lesser. Now also, come. Ayo. We can repeat after them to encourage them. Go.
Namaste Narasimhaya. Pralada Daine. Hiranyakashi Purvakshaha. Shilatankanakalaye. Ito Narsimha Parato Narsimha. Yato Yato Yami Tato Narsimha. Bahir Narsimha Hridaye Narsimha. Narasingha Madhim Sharanam Prapade. Vakara Kamala Vare Naka Adbhuta Shringa Dalita Hiranyakashipu Tanubhringa Keshavadrita Narahari Rupa Jai Jagadish Hare Jagadish Hare. Jai Jagadish Hare. Jai. Jai Narsimha Dev. Narsimha Dev. Narsimha Dev. Jai Narsimha Dev. Pralad Maharaj, Pralad Maharaj, Jaya Pralad Maharaj, Jaya Jaya Prabhu. जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 जय जय प्रभुपाद नित्य गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्य गौर हरि बोल नरसिंह जय भक्त की जय नित्य गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि 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 बोल हरे कृष्णा थैंक यू वेरी मच प्लीज हैव प्रसादम एंड lot of times people when I say prasadam they think a little prasadam take like this and go it's not like that it's full dinner prasadam so please have sumptuously and please honor prasadam Hare Krishna thank you very much